Been?
I'm using Twitch.
PC.
Twitch, yeah, it's the PC gaming PC show. PC gaming one. And it's on Twitch. Just search up PC gamer Twitch.
Gamer.
I hope they don't get technical. This is the last fucking conference of the year.
Yep.
This is it.
That's until they throw a surprise at a conference at us. And they're like, wait, we're not done.
Wait, hold on, we got more.
Oh, wait, there's more.
Okay. Twitch.tv. That's me.
That's me. Holy shit, seriously? God damn. Going hard on it today, aren't you?
Who, me?
Fucking cat. Rolling it the last I've ever heard him roll it.
Rolling.
Who's Simpson Master? I forget.
Who?
Who's Simpson One Master? I forget.
It's Loophole.
Oh, yeah.
What, is he in it?
Nah. I just saw you add him.
A famous player video showed his house filled with hats, dogs, chicken, or cheese wheels. What the fuck is that?
What? Oh, they're doing quizzes, I think?
Yeah.
Yeah, they have one more, and then the show starts.
Rolling.
PC gaming show. Word. Let's do this. Update.
Okay.
Baby.
Got a minute left.
Yeah, I hope they should announce a new graphics card.
Oh boy.
PC. Well, actually. AMD released their stuff, announced their stuff like today, like 8-10 hours ago.
Did they?
Yeah.
What did they announce?
The Fury and its specs.
Oh, fuck yeah. I can't wait for that.
Yeah.
I'll put that on my computer and play Meme Run.
Meme Run.
Highest favorite. Graphics. Yeah.
33 seconds.
Oh, fuck yeah. I can't wait.
PC, yo, PC.
It's going to freeze it. It's going to freeze it free.
Freeze at 3? What?
Yeah.
When you said PC like 33
gamer. Twitch.tv/PC Gamer.
When you were 33 seconds, I was at like 20, so.
Oh, where?
Well, there you go. Now you know how
much. Yeah, I'm a little bit behind, I guess.
You know how much the stream is delayed, though. Alright. One. Oh, shit. That's a PC.
That's an ugly ass case.
Good God, that sucks.
Wow. He's about to show us. It's. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
AMD's letterbox.
Oh yeah, put that mother chip in there. Oh yeah. Oh fuck. Oh yeah, put the coolant. Oh
this is,
yeah.
This is how you install a CPU.
Oh fuck yeah, put the RAM. Oh, RAM it up my ass. Oh yeah. Oh fuck. Oh, I'm almost there. Yeah, put the GPU. Oh fuck. Oh my god, you turned it on. Oh yeah.
The dream.
Thank you.
Radeon with a Razer mount.
Epic joke.
I'm bored. Oh, Mountain Dew.
Oh, of course.
Oh my god, are they really gonna...
Dude, they have a fucking...
Let me guess. Oh, it's waterproof or some stupid shit?
Or Epic May May.
Oh man, it's just everywhere. Jesus.
Looks like piss. Oh my god, my favorite games. All of these 2001 games.
All the hits from 2006.
And 1990. Oh, was that Fallout? Oh my god.
That Doom?
Oh my god, was that Doom? Oh, that's Papers, Please.
That's curious, man.
That's Half-Life. A Hitman. That's a game. Oh my god.
It's like we're going back in time.
We're still there. Oh, Mark Hamill. Oh, great.
Legally. Minesweeper.
We better get a fucking, get something big here. I heard they're going to show games. It's not like it's not going to be a game conference.
I hear there will be games.
Well, at first when I heard PC gaming show, I mean gaming, but I thought maybe it was going to be about all the things you need to do gaming. Like, we got to talk about motherboards. And oh, look at the new motherboard. Oh, look at Minecraft. That G looks Yankee. That's...
It was all a big lead up for PC Gamer.
I meant to say janky. Oh. Powered by PC. Oh, AMD presents PC Gaming Show powered by PC Gamer.
Ladies and gentlemen. Hmm. Welcome to the PC Gaming Show! This is pretty shit already.
I know, right? Miyamoto! Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah!
Yes.
Thank you so much for coming out today. Hello, everyone on the internet. Thank you for tuning in. As you can tell, I'm extremely excited to be here because PC is an amazing platform. It's an open platform. We've been seeing increasing advances in technology, better and better tools. We have this amazing, diverse range of...
Who the fuck dressed you?
All realized.
Take your pants off.
We invited a huge number of guests today, and none of them said no. So we have a packed schedule. Like, look at how many cue cards I have. We're going to go through all of them starting right now. So without any further ado...
None of them, like, well, thank God.
Oh my God, that's like a whole fucking binder full of bullshit.
Let's welcome our first guest. He works on a game called Killing Floor 2.
Oh, Killing Floor 2.
It's John Gibson from Tripwire Interactive.
Woo!
Good to see you, Sean. Welcome, John. Join me on this unusually large sofa.
Yeah, I'll just lay down right here.
That's right, if you want to tell me about any of your problems, we're going to have to wait till after the show.
Okay.
Because I want to talk about...
Let's just bear on this. This isn't going to be a good show.
Wait, hold on.
Good start.
We can do it. Let's talk about a game that came out 6 months ago. Yeah, okay.
Oh, cool, man.
Yeah, sure.
Well, you know there ain't going to be no announcements like it's coming to consoles.
Oh, no way.
Not screw that up. I mean, that is so important.
If Half-Life 3 isn't announced, there won't be an PC gaming conference.
Pretty much.
Was that a threat?
Yeah, that's about right.
Screw that up.
I think that was a threat.
We're out on early access, and we wanted to get that core gameplay super fun, super
solid. I forgot Killing Floor 2 is already out.
That's been fucking ages.
Oh, I don't know about ages.
It's been out for at least a couple of months.
Oh, okay, that's well. We're getting a lot of 2 months. Really interesting
feedback. It's ages for being like given any sort of time at E3.
I can imagine. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, one of the things that we discovered.
Welcome to the PC Gaming Show at E3. Let's talk about old shit.
Let's talk about Killing Floor 2. That's a good way to start it. Yeah, Sony did Last Guardian. Fucking Microsoft did Halo 5. Let's talk about some old shit.
Why not Killing Floor? I
mean, he mixed up his cards. He actually put the middle one where, you know, there was downtime as the first one on mistake. So Half-Life 3 will be announced randomly.
Regular updates where we're telling them, you know, this is what we're working on.
Here's in case you are unaware where you were, their entire background is made out of circuitry.
With a game, it's got bugs, you know, and you
just know, like a computer.
It's like a computer. Wow. Computers look like that.
They really thought about this.
Yeah.
For at least a couple of minutes. Let's take a
look. They should have just made the whole entire wall out of motherboards.
Yeah.
Now that would have been cool.
That would have been expensive.
Oh my god, look at the new advanced Gore-Tex. Oh my god. Oh, wow, look at that. Look at those Gibbs. The giblets. Ew. Oh, gross. Ew. Oh, gross. Oh, they exploded. Oh, they're dead.
Yep. Pretty sure this sure is Killing Floor 2.
Yep, that sure is the sequel to Killing Floor.
Can confirm.
I like Killing Floor, but I never played Killing Floor 2. I heard it's pretty okay. That's about it.
I like Killing Floor. I don't think it's big enough to open a fucking conference at E3.
They better announce something big. Yeah, Killing Floors.
Giblet Floor.
Giblet Floor. You know, I've seen this video a few times. Look at all those fat nerds.
I never don't laugh because the gore and the gut spraying everywhere is hilarious. And I understand this is like a pretty big technical innovation for you guys.
Yeah, so it's something we're really excited about. We've been working with a hardware partner on this technology for some time, but it wasn't quite ready for the initial release. And really what it does is...
Oh, we worked on these features, but weren't ready for the initial release. Okay, that's good that you just fucking shy out without it.
Yeah. Yeah, the game isn't finished and won't be for the next 2 years, but you should pay full retail price.
Things
please.
Float inside of other things and fluid, and it all works together. Of course, when you give technology like that to a bunch of twisted people like Tripwire, we're going to make blood...
Twisted people like us at Tripwire. I'm sorry, you're not, like, enough of a name for anybody to, like... Oh, Tripwire! Those guys at Tripwire and the games they make.
I don't know, I think they're a big name now. You know, Killing Floor 1 sold, about, what, 10,000 copies?
It's a video game. Yeah,
they're huge.
Yeah, that's huge.
Man. Almost as big as Valve.
Yeah, now, of course, for me, Valve, they should make their own streaming service. Killing Floor,
so it's a nice sort of balance. I mean, what else do we get the chance to see in this video? So
one of the things that we're people with like hairlines like that shouldn't spike their hair off.
What do you mean? It looks, he looks great.
Listen, I have no problem with the older Miz sitting here on this fucking couch.
His forehead's so big, they can make a map of it in Killing Floor. And then let them fight.
Looks like he belongs in Code Lyoko.
Code Lyoko.
Yeah, you know, the anime with the big ass foreheads.
I know. He looks like he's as realistic as the CG in Code Lyoko.
Yeah.
A bunch of new weapons. We're going to be shipping the Firebug perk and the Demolition perk. As you saw, you know, there's a rock.
Yeah, someone has a big forehead. This has a big forehead.
Look at that stack of blue paper. Shotgun that shoots flame. We're about 10 minutes in, and we're only on one, and we're not even done. And really, you know, one of the things
How long do you think this is going to be?
Oh, 20 minutes.
What you see?
They're going to get through all the other ones really quick.
You'll give up on this after like half an hour and then come back to it like 5 hours later and that like half that stack will be gone through and I'll still be streaming. His tie will be like unkept and...
Nobody's in the audience anymore.
Yeah.
the guy interviewing people already took off his suit off. He unbuttoned his fucking... He took off his tie.
He's just leaning back in his chair, not giving a shit. Just like...
Anything else you want to say to the audience before you...
Fuck you.
You know, I guess Dan Gibson.
One more thing I should probably share before,
what?
Before we go.
Okay.
We've been working on something...
Half-Life 3 confirmed.
And
ooh.
We're gonna reveal something.
Oh, something new. Okay,
right
fine.
On the stage right now.
Cool.
No one has ever seen. Let's take a look.
What is well, it? They sure got the scoop on the world exclusive from Tripwire Entertainment.
Oh, man. Killing Floor 3. 2's not even done. Oh, my God. It looks early access.
You can smell the early access. Yeah. Like it's leaking from my monitor.
I could smell the urban early access from here. Oh my god, it's a war game. Battlefield 5.
This looks pretty sweet.
Hey, Tripwire, instead of like making a new game, why don't you finish Killing Floor 2?
No, they'll finish it. Don't worry about it.
Don't even worry about it. They'll finish it out later.
Yeah, they'll do that later. They'll get their B team to finish it.
What they have
this?
A B team?
Is this the...
It's like five people, what B team?
Day of Defeat 2.
The whole studio's a B team.
What the hell is this? Is this gonna be Killing Floor except you're in the war zone in the beginning?
It really looks shit.
Coming
now. It looks really shit.
I don't know, it looks okay for, you know, for Tripwire. Yeah.
If this was like shown to you in like 2006, you'd be like, this doesn't look like Xbox 360.
Well, hold on. This isn't like...
This is a new generation. This looks like a shitty cutscene.
We'll see. It might be good. I don't know.
Yeah.
Rising Storm 2? Vietnam.
Huh.
That was Rising Storm 2.
You may have heard
there would be reveals. I don't know what the fuck Rising Storm is. Within the first 10 minutes of the show, so far so good. Is that the first game they made? Next
guest, I guess so.
Okay, yeah. Today.
Oh, the second guest could even make it.
He works on a game called Star Citizen, and every single time.
Oh, Star Citizen! I'm already bored.
Who's the Woo guy in the back? Who's on point? The first Woo. Nice work. $84 million in funding. And
every woo!
I see a new clip, I get re-hyped all over again.
Star Citizen has $84 million of funding?
Of the CEO of Cloud Imperium.
Sweet. What is it, a card game? Hope it's a card game. I want to play cards.
Welcome to Ealing.
Oh my god, look at that nerd.
This is fortunately where I am.
Chris Roberts even has a nerd name.
Los Angeles for the inaugural PC gaming press conference.
He just couldn't afford the plane ticket. He only has $84 million.
You guys gave us $84 million. I couldn't afford a $150 plane ticket.
E3 and other.
Sorry, guys.
Conventions. And,
I'll just make this shitty video on our shitty mocap set.
He's very busy mocapping.
Like we're shitting on everything. Who cares?
He doesn't want to go to San Francisco in case he gets beat up. Come on. Performance
capture. So what is this, RTS? I don't know what Star Citizen is. I know it has like made a lot of money.
It's a Kickstarter. That's what it is.
Yeah, I know that. It made $84 million. But I know what was the other one that kept making money? Is that Troy Baker? That was Troy Baker.
That was Troy Baker.
I wouldn't be here doing it without.
Who's the what's the other one that made like a good like what $70 million from like Kickstarter? It's like a PC game.
Studio
which one?
Shinmuther.
Shinmuther. Yeah, it's RTS.
What, you mean Elite Dangerous?
Was that it?
Well, it's another sort of like space game. It didn't make $70 million, but.
Okay. I thought there was something else. Maybe it was Star Citizen I'm thinking of. But... Oh, good.
Ukulele.
You can clip right through the ship so far. So good.
Sweet.
Next year I will be at the PC Gaming Conference.
Oh, he did a clip right fucking through it.
Yep. And I'm well, it's early footage. He said it's early footage, to be fair.
Yeah. Whenever there's like an English accent in any sort of E3 thing, it's always like a disappointing announcement or something you don't care about. Every time.
We are talking about E3 hit fire. What's up, Bidier? We hyped every single time. And as we have so many developers... You're watching the video game? We have technologists to talk about what it's like to develop
the things on which games are built. So please join me in welcoming the chief gaming scientist of AMD, Richard Huddy.
Chief AMD. Gaming scientist.
Richard, you bear
chief gaming scientist.
Oh my god, he came with a briefcase.
Is that what happens when you have like a...
He's catching in his mind, I think.
Is that like when you have a doctorate in autism or something, you become a chief gaming scientist?
Doctrine in autism.
Chief gaming scientist, apart from being a
chief gaming scientist.
And to most people.
Chief gaming scientist.
That must be such a degrading job title. See,
that's nice. He's at the family reunion. He's like, oh, what are you doing? I'm a doctor. I'm a lawyer. How about you, Richard? I'm a chief gaming specialist.
It's nice. Oh, is that like Let's Plays on YouTube or something?
It's worse. It's worse. I just look at motherboards. I say, "Oh, that's pretty cool."
That's why we have the bright lights. It's to confuse you and blind you.
And confused I am, as is usually the case. But the
okay, so Star Citizen is a space simulator. Okay. Where I talk about some of the I saw that when it was floating around, but I thought maybe it'd be good. But I guess not.
Second
card now.
I know.
Pretty good.
I know everybody loves. Star games, so much but more that that can do. Or space simulators.
So many different challenges that PC not gamers me. Want to tackle nowadays. They want to have. How do you? Yep. How does AMD approach it?
Well, it gets you a long way when you start with Lara Croft having 300 or 400 polygons, and you get excited about that. Have to say, when you get to 1 million or 5 million, that's a pretty cool place to be. But there is a lot more to it than that. It's true. So, just this morning we introduced.
See, Gore, I wasn't lying.
What?
Cards. We were
introduced a new line of graphics cards this morning.
Oh yeah, I didn't say you were lying.
I was.
I didn't say you were lying.
Telling the truth.
For once in your life, you told me the truth. I didn't. I wasn't surprised.
AMD Radeon.
I thought AMD fucking announces a new graphics card every week, though. And no, this one's gonna be better. It's gonna make your graphics look like nice. Is this the 8K graphics card? Great, I heard this one's supposed to be able to play games in 8K.
I hope so. Which sounds, I want to play games in 8K when I don't even have a 4K monitor.
There's not even a 4K, I mean an 8K monitor yet.
Not yet.
Can I get a 4K TV first?
This is your top of the range graphics card, so will it actually be able to run GTA 5 without it stuttering like a piece of shit? I can't do that. Come on, we can't make miracles.
No game.
I mean, come on.
No,
GTA
no,
5 is CPU intensive. We no, all know this. They no, don't give a fuck about the graphics card.
No motherboard can run GTA 5 at full sound. And if you go into FPS mode, then you're fucked.
So can this graphics card actually run GTA 5? Oh, what, are you a retard? Of course you can't. You fucking stupid.
What the fuck are you thinking?
What do you think, we're made out of talent? Well,
that needs a pretty powerful. You want an optimized video? Scientist.
You want an optimized video game? The game originally designed was for PC, and you want this shit to be optimized? Get the fuck out of here!
Yeah, my face. That's Rockstar.
That's some bullshit.
Super fast and deliver output really. Really extraordinarily quickly. A 90th of a second is a very short period.
God, imagine all those people in that room right now with their journalists thinking like, oh shit, I went to the wrong fucking conference. I miss Sony so I could arrive at this one on time.
What a goddamn shame.
Oh my god, no one cares. Just show us some games. And I mean real games.
So as a video game scientist, is your job to be a long ass ad?
Yeah, that's it. They're literally just talking with a sponsor about their shit.
DX12 is gonna do what
Windows 10
AMD have always wanted to be able to do with the hardware, and that is deliver the maximum value that we can out of a piece of hardware. It's not about always shipping a new piece of hardware because we can trick you into paying for it. Actually, what we'd really like you to do is to get the maximum value out of it, because you'll come back as a customer who knows that we've tried hard for you if we do that. DX12 really rocks when it comes to doing that. DX12 opens up every CPU core and opens up...
This guy's a walking press release, isn't he?
He really is.
He's a walking, talking, don't give a fuck.
He's a kind of... He's a fucking email press release that you ignore.
He is the email press release.
He's reading it off that guy's forehead.
it's so big they're just projecting the words on there.
You can't see it.
Yeah, they're using the HoloLens.
Yes.
He just opens up his sentence with June the 17th, 2015, San Francisco, AMD press release.
Hello, Chris. I would like to tell you about our new stuff. And we would like to thank you for your continued support.
It sounds like they're getting somewhere with this. Hang on.
What would they say?
Something about rendering in video games. DX12
completely solves it. Really beautiful. Well, isn't that the whole point of these fucking graphics cards? I mean, I see the
graphics card here. Oh, he's talking about DX12. Metal, austere looking case here. He brought goodies. In it. Well, you got some weed?
Pie? Just at the moment, but I hope it's pie.
Give you my mind of right briefcase.
It's Gwyneth Paltrow's head. With one of your later no.
Just a suitcase of $100 bill just for PC gamer for having fucking talk about this bullshit on the show.
What, a whole suitcase with just $100 bill?
Here's your suitcase. Okay, don't open it until I leave. There's a bomb in there.
There's a $100 bill. Under the $100 bill is a bomb. But here with me on
the sofa. Out of the I want him to drop that.
He teases a lot.
I want him to do what Michael Bay did, where he's like, I can't do this. I can't do this.
The RQ is not working.
That is a thick fucking graphics card. How is my motherboard going to hold that shit up?
Have you seen the TDP of the new AMD stuff, Matt? This one from
Asus. No, I've not.
It's 300 watts.
I like that you didn't ask me. A superior 4K fucking insulting.
300 watts? Fuck
yeah.
Me.
I know about all that, and you didn't ask me.
I'm going to need a new fucking PSU.
PSU, was that?
I think the show's going well. Twitch is probably giving me a 6.5 out of 10 right
you
now.
Did so
knows what they're giving you.
You didn't.
Either way.
You just say so people give him a 6.5 right now for the conference?
Yeah.
Not that high.
And I won a case.
I give it a 4.
Look after that for me, yeah?
Thank you so much.
And I'll take these away, but it's not a sign that
I'm
going
to crash.
I look forward to receiving
what?
I'm
going
to
take.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Wait, what? What'd you say?
Thank you.
Something of mine crashed.
About the technology. It's time to see some of the
I'm going
to
take these graphics cards away from you because it's not because I don't trust you, but you know, I'll just leave them backstage. That's okay, I didn't want them. Shit, anyway. I wouldn't have stolen them.
No, that's okay. It sucks my ass anyway.
Please join me in welcoming Jean-François Dugard.
Nah, get NVIDIA. I'm not a fucking retard, mate.
Jacques Beletet.
Who the fuck? Yeah, who are they? I don't care.
Oh, French dudes.
Oh, great. You got to talk about Assassin's
now,
Creed Syndicate.
Despite the fact that I've shamed myself by referring to it as a 6-core monitor,
oh
I
my God.
You, I am a true PC gamer.
We're making an indie game that's like a cross between Minecraft and DayZ. Wonderful.
Minecraft
it's quite a lot of pressure. It's quite a lot of...
I couldn't think of a better combination.
Mostly.
It's very different. It sounds very innovative.
Yeah, indeed.
Sounds like State of Decay.
The first time when we started to work on this title, a lot of you guys were looking at us, and please, like, let's make sure that you guys do a good job. So
we're the underdogs.
Exactly.
Yeah, you guys are the underdogs,
really
definitely.
All about, like, making sure that we
fuck
were living
you.
Up to the to you guys. And today, now that we did the Human Revolution, and it seemed it was an appreciated game, we have now people are having a lot
we
of
we did the Human Revolution.
And the pressure
what?
Switched from a different...
He said we did the Human Revolution.
You can never release a good game and then have a follow-up. That's
we revolutionized humanity today.
So, I mean, how has the world changed since Human Revolution?
Well, we're 2 years after Human Revolution, and
this is Deus Ex. I didn't even know that. He said Human Revolution, right?
Abilities and
whatnot.
Yeah. Oh.
And now 2 years
okay.
later, after the events,
I'm excited now.
I am mildly. And,
I didn't know who these fuckers were.
They're French.
But that could be anything. All these French fucks make games.
So
okay, so Deus Ex Mankind Divided.
Exactly.
Hopefully they don't talk about like AMD won't be able to process the graphics.
Now we live
okay,
in a world
fuck.
Where people augmented people
go suck AMD
ghettos,
dick.
Et cetera.
The D stands for
and,
dick.
And Adam Jensen is back now. He's not working for Serif Industries anymore. He's working for
I'm just playing for Stranglehold 2 to be honest.
I bet.
agency and his goal is to
speed runs
over there.
Yeah.
But also he has a double agenda. He's trying to get at the people in the shadows and
I don't talk about it. Let's just see it. Come on, man.
Can get through them.
And we got a chance also to talk about what new possibilities were available with the new technology. And we know that bigger and more is not always better. So let's take a look at this Dawn engine video so we can talk about how you are using it.
Okay, they're
going to
show the engine, but hopefully they also show gameplay.
And,
that means.
You know, having just seen this video just moments before the show began, I'm noticing so many more objects on the screen.
So many cucumbers.
There's
so many cucumbers.
But that's the thing.
Everybody thought that was funny.
So many cucumbers.
Look at all those cucumbers.
Clutter.
That's a lot of cucumbers.
That's a lot of cucumbers. I make a lot of salads out of that.
And the game is about details. It's about like there's so much visual layering and now
look
with
all
the
that colors
and DirectX 12, we can push it, you know, so much higher than what we did before.
Global illumination.
And tons of other bells and whistles as well. Tress effects for the hair and Adam's beard and all that. So yeah.
Does his beard grow like in The Witcher?
I hope so.
The actual environment with all these interactable objects going on. I mean, I assume
it's pretty hot.
Extremely chaotic and hard to control the visual elements. How do you?
Looks like someone pissed on the floor.
Let the art style match.
Yeah,
up.
It's Detroit. Or wherever.
Welcome to Detroit.
The last game was in Detroit. I don't know where this one takes place. I think fucking New York. Same place.
Some ghetto. So Detroit, basically.
Same thing.
Arguing with the artists.
Oh, good. They're talking over each other. That's good.
Oh, good.
The fights happen.
It's always good.
It's smoother.
I'm glad that we're talking over them, talking over each other.
Yeah.
It's definitely not confusing.
Nope.
how do you tend to play through the game? Because there's always so many different options available. I
feel what like a styling beard.
Finding your own way.
He's styling and profound. Look at him.
Sorry, what's the question? What, how do you play Deus Ex?
Oh, they're playing? Oh my god! I don't understand it. So, wait, is this the first gameplay?
I like to play stealth. Kinda,
well, I mean, you saw gameplay in the trailer where they didn't do a demo.
That's pretty sweet. Are you doing stealth?
Oh, what a pussy. Go in there and shoot him in the fucking head.
It's like, I want to have...
We're in the fucking head!
You know, I want to have the best of both.
Everybody thinks he's...
Can this guy be any fucking slower, though?
You know, I go forward, I feel like I'm James Bond.
That's how stealth is.
I go backward, I feel like I'm Rambo.
Just kill him. Fucking kill him. No, don't use that shit. Nah. Go in there and stab with your fucking arms. Oh, they skipped ahead.
That's not very stealthy at all, actually.
Wait, did they just skip ahead?
So I'll yeah, be
gentle you're an impulsive.
Okay, so they're not playing.
Right. It's not live gameplay.
Ooh, that's good. That looks better at third person shooting.
All the different ways that people are going to play through the
that's
game.
Good.
It's always like Jen was saying, like
no,
we
someone's
we
tired.
Way with the team, and it's always
why Deus Ex and I look forward to it?
What we're trying to
oh, really?
We know that
why you didn't like the last one?
Four gameplay pillars.
I played it a long life,
so as we build the adventure, as we build the missions, all the challenges.
Like
we
have I don't even did hear him talk right now until this gameplay's done.
Going to do. So we do a lot of map reviews, and when we play it, also like.
Oh man, that snipe.
At, what the possibilities are, and sometimes we're okay, it's cool like if you're the stealthy player, but what about the combat player?
Oh, he's like almost halfway done with the cards already.
So it's a back and forth like that that allows us to really
the
maps and the challenges to make sure that everybody's going to have something.
And
to,
yet we always see players do things that we never thought was possible, that we never even imagined.
They're pretty obnoxious in that way, aren't they?
Yeah.
Well, either way, gentlemen, thank you so
the footage
much.
Looks beautiful, all 10 beautiful. Seconds of it. I can't
wait to get players do things they right, never thought gentlemen. Would be possible, like clipping through walls of the box.
Thank you.
Because you can do that in Human Revolution.
Oh, yeah, you can.
That was close. Hey, that's I'm a ninja. Thanks so much. Yes. Now, of course,
what the fuck is going on? That was quite an awkward walk off. What the fuck was that?
Oh, I didn't pay attention. What did they like fucking like?
They almost fucking started making out.
Oh, cool.
Hold on. Not easy.
I don't know what happened.
I like the woo guy over here.
Half-Life 3 Epic May.
I can't wait until memes get creative, me.
Coming up next, we have a video to talk a little bit about the history of Total War.
If this guy's gonna mention Half-Life 3 by fucking name and they don't announce it.
Oh, good.
Half-Life 3 is literally going to happen.
That's fuck Tears for Fears right in their ass. Thanks, Lordy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Lord.
Lordy.
Oh, hell yeah.
Actually, I kind of like this cover.
It's lord18yet.com.
I kind of like this cover.
That's pretty good. It was in the Assassin's Creed game last year.
It was in the last Dracula movie, too. It's in everything.
It's in a lot of things.
I don't really see how it fits. Oh god. Alright.
Oh, this is Assassin's Creed.
No,
where is it?
This is a Roman game. Total War.
Total War.
What? You know what? I've always. Oh, pirates now?
Oh, it's Assassin's Creed. I'm
wait,
sorry.
Hold on. Oh, okay, yeah, that's right. I forgot Roman people use bows. Bunch of assholes. Ah, that looks really good. Too bad it probably doesn't look like that in the game. I heard the game was like, this game right here was broken as fuck when it first came out. Oh, we're gonna get flagged. Through the world. Is it real? Find you. Hold your hands while the walls come crumbling down.
It's Medieval 3.
Oh, no, there he said what it was. Almost made it. So sad they had to fade it. Everybody wants to rule the world. Everybody wants to. Everybody wants to rule the world. The world. Dragons? What is this fucking game?
What is this?
Is this
everything.
Just all the Total
combine
Wars?
All the things.
Oh, it's just a fucking montage. Oh, wait, Total War. Wait, it cut away too quick.
15 years of Total War.
Is it Total War Warhammer?
Yes,
the fuck?
Total War Warhammer. They cut away real quick.
Yeah.
Why the game isn't called Total Warhammer.
Yeah, I was about to say. Well, we've got Total War Warhammer. That sounds fucking dumb and redundant.
Equal yeah.
Should be Total
really,
War.
But,
Total Warhammer.
If you guys want to call it Total
Total
War,
Total Wank. Hammer,
then that's a pretty cool trailer. The montage.
Yes. One victory has been achieved thus far. You know, I immediately want to ask about in the videos, and for anyone who's played the Total War franchise, it's so much rooted in history. And now you have this fantasy setting.
It's magic races. I thought he was going to say magic racism.
Wait, same people that own Total War, same people that own Warhammer?
I mean, I think so. No, is that not true?
Warhammer's the Games Workshop. Total War is the creative assembly, I think.
Yeah, same guys that made the last Alien game. Giant creatures, flying creatures,
as you say, magic. Colonial Marines alien?
No, the fucking good one. The one where you have to be quiet. Where it'll get you. In a Total War context,
things we've never done before, and things that you've never seen in a game before. Yeah, because immediately. Oh, Total War was fucking announced last month. Warhammer.
Total Warhammer.
Yeah, we.
Well, I was going to say, you've got your lords and your heroes, pretty much like in the tabletop game. And your lords, they're going to be your army generals, and you're going to have famous people.
And the upcoming turn-based strategy, real-time like tactics Warcraft, video game in development.
That's every fucking Total War game.
Going to be a bit like
published by Sega! In Total Sega. War.
Why is Total War Warhammer like not priests, capitalized?
Witch hunters, even. And warrior priests.
Why is there no hyphen as well?
And wizards, of course.
And there's a new feature as well, where when you use these heroes on the campaign game, if you embed them in an army and then fight a battle, they'll be there in the battle fighting, you know. Deep skills tree, so deeper than we've ever been, so you can really get into the character and the narrative of these heroes. And that's something that, you know, we've never pushed this far in a turn.
Are you bored because you bleed your gaming loads?
I blew my load with Nintendo, alright?
I mean, for me, it's lifelong Warhammer.
All those Japanese video games.
Oh man, I can't wait for Star Fax, and that's it.
To see him then animated. Epic Yarn, Yoshi.
Yeah, but that was announced like 4 years ago. It's still not out.
Star Fox on Wii U was announced like.
Yeah, this is PC
conference. Yeah, but it wasn't shown. Yoshi's fucking Epic Woolly World was shown like 2 years ago.
The only reason I'm watching this step is for Half-Life 3. And it's Half-Life 3 doesn't come out, even though the fucking announcer said something about Half-Life 3, if it doesn't come out, I'm going to piss all over San Diego.
It's not going to.
Well, why the fuck did the host talk about it?
Half-Life 3 is never happening.
The head of Xbox from Microsoft.
Phil Spencer! Yeah, Phil Spencer! Spencer. Phil, he's the man that helped Xbox.
Nice you. Do you mind?
Welcome to the PC Gaming Show.
I'm
bringing
you.
Oh shit, got a cameo.
Phil.
Welcome everybody to the
PC Gaming
We're
Show.
We're watching PC Gaming.
So Phil.
Okay, over to the bed, isn't it?
I would be thrilled for you to tell me a little bit about what Microsoft is here for.
Oh, okay. I thought they were talking about games.
You know this. Well, first, I just want to say I think it's great that there's a PC gaming conference press event here at E3. I think that's fantastic.
What the fuck happened to the right side of his face?
He was hit by a car.
When the opportunity to
go on Tiki Face.
Had a fucking stroke.
We had the opportunity to get involved with this, and
he was frying some pancakes the other day, and he fell. The pancake batter went all over his face. He was like, Xbox, turn off.
And as the person now, who
that's his first reaction.
It really does look like he had a stroke, though.
Maybe he did. He's just like, all these games. After Sony like announced like three things that ripped their asshole apart, he had a stroke.
They're just like, oh, so many timed exclusive on the Xbox. Oh, I'm so excited.
Last Guardian.
Obviously, coming out in July, one of their early moves was to make the free upgrade for people. Really, we thought about
Windows
that
10.
From a developer standpoint, that as developers look at a common ecosystem with everybody on as much as we can, one
I can't wait to get
Windows
10.
It easier.
And then wish I had Windows 7.
So allowing for free upgrades in the first year so that people, their test matrix, our test matrix just gets easier. That would be great. Building DirectX 12 and make it common across our platform. If you're working on DirectX 12, Xbox Live, so if you're interested in Xbox Live, the same API set, the same service, just trying to make it easier for developers. As
hell yeah, Windows 10, so I can play cell phone games on my desktop.
Phil Collins needs to shut the fuck up and show some games. I'm getting pissed.
Show me Half-Life 3.
For me, games, Xbox One exclusive. I think there are opportunities for cross-platform, but I also think
Windows
there are games
exclusive.
That exist on a television, and there's games that exist PC
Man,
and keyboard and mouse on a PC.
Everybody
and,
pissed.
It's not our job to dictate where games are developed or the kind of games that developers want to build, but giving developers the options, the opportunity, creating the widest canvas we can for creativity is what I've seen in my time in the gaming space that leads to the best games, and that's why I think we're all here.
Well, you now have the chance to announce some of the upcoming games that we PC gamers can get excited about.
Yeah, there's been a lot of push for us to do more in the first party, and we will. We're dedicated to that. But I don't like to make promises.
I don't like announcing
things.
Come
on,
let's just
eat free. We're going to have some people come out. But one of the franchises that a lot of people have asked me about is
Fable.
Killer Instinct on the PC, finally, fucking 20 years after being on Xbox One.
And
only season one, though.
On PC, to play on console, to play back and forth. I think it's a great franchise for us. You've seen fighting games do very well. And it's the beginning
cross-platform
for us.
Again,
I can make some grandiose promises.
Okay, that's cool.
I'm just not that kind of person. As our portfolio builds out on Windows, you'll hear more and more from us about what we're building.
And I also am so excited to bring some guests up to the stage to talk about the titles that they are working on. So without any further ado, I'm so excited about these two in particular. Please join me in welcoming David Eckelberry and James Finney from Fable Legends and Gigantic.
Oh, I knew Fable Legends. All these losers. Look at that guy with the beard.
Come join me.
All
hello,
these
welcome. Welcome. You are not
what's
allowed
Lionhead
to speak without a formal handshake.
Oh. Fable.
Ah, yes.
Yeah. Black and white.
That's out of the way.
Black and white, yeah.
David. I just saw the footage.
Fable the Journey.
We're gonna go straight into it right now.
That's their most popular
this
one.
This is footage from Fable Legends. It's
Milo on Xbox Kinect.
Yeah.
Tell me about what we're seeing.
So this is Fable Heroes on Xbox Live Arcade.
What we're looking at is
the movies.
Set of environments.
The movies.
we're going to just show off, right? The great
Black
thing about
and White
Fable
2.
Legends, it's a game that you can play on your Xbox One. It's a game you can play on a Windows 10 PC.
That's a good thing to say
and
about
what
your
we're
game.
Really getting to build right
now, our game is a game you can play. Right.
Is
that's it, bye.
Cool
un-fucking
world.
Real.
You, can spend time
you should say, hey, fuckers, this is the game you're going to play. Cool if you don't, I'm going to find your house. Fucking knock on the door. I'm going to tell you, hey, fuck you.
Hey, play my game.
You or and now I'm going to come in your house, turn on your Xbox way, One, you and make you play it for 20 hours.
I want to ask about the way that you are able to use the, you know, DirectX technology.
Yep.
We've talked about
this
how
game looks like it could be good, though.
Better. How do you
I love Fable. So.
Basically, what it gives us the power to do
I
is
it turn-based?
No, it's a fundamentally regular like hack and slash RPG.
Okay.
Oh, cool! I want to see these assholes.
What's it called? Fable what?
Legends.
Oh, Legends. Yeah.
It's a free to play game. You know, a
level of I was gonna say yeah, it's free to play, so it's not gonna be that good.
And it's going to be a game. It also has like a MOBA aspect to it or something. Yeah.
And, you know,
I'll just let him talk about
stigma
or
that people have associated
saying
with
all
that.
The shit.
Walk me through the choice around the business model.
I think, you know, we thought about it's a new kind of game that we were building in Fable Legends. And we really wanted the opportunity for everyone to play it and make their own decision on it. It's a different kind of game. It's not exactly like Fable 1, 2, and 3. It has the opportunity for multiplayer, has this new villain that can play and play oppositionally. And
basically, this PC conference is telling us our PC is basically alternative Xbox Ones.
Simply to play
yeah.
Kinda.
We talked about it a lot. That just meant that we wanted to put it in their hands.
Well, they brought the dude from fucking Xbox. I mean, what do you guys expect?
How does this allow you to do an extended long-term...
When the fuck is this game
we're
come out?
We're gonna plan for years of content.
Years of content? What?
Like that. Is Legends on it?
Some way that we could deliver that to the user.
Is Legends dead?
When is it supposed... When did they announce it? I've heard of it before.
I don't know. There's a beta that's supposed to come out. I don't remember if they said what... And keep year it's coming out at the Microsoft press conference because they did
and
show
I mean,
it there.
I cannot disagree with the beauty that we saw there, but of course, I'm super excited it's going to be on the PC, so I get to play it oh so easily.
Yeah, and it's great. It's really easy to play on the PC. Yeah. You can plug in a controller, you can use mouse and keyboard, you can do whatever you want.
Fable, I'm a legend.
James, I've been following
Fable,
the
legend.
Quite a while.
Continues.
Take a look at some of the footage you brought here today.
Oh, cool, that's how you're familiar with. Yo, let me see that footy.
Release date still 2015, according to Wikipedia.
So, as the name implies, it centers around these gigantic creatures. It's 5-on-5 PvP. Play it on Windows 10. Play it on Xbox.
Oh, that's a fucking game.
And each team consists of 5 unique heroes, but they also have this guardian.
Hey, HD.
And is the objective in the game.
PC.
So, you've got your guardian, the enemy team has theirs, and whichever guardian dies,
in the Skype
their
call.
Team loses.
Yeah,
and I know
near
that
worry.
One of the core elements to the gameplay is that it's
Matt.
A mix of
what?
A shooter.
Adrian's
and a
in the chat.
How do you merge those two together? For
Adrian, do you want to make
it's
up?
It's actually been pretty fluid and really fun for us from a development standpoint. So,
he's
you know,
probably
if we
gone
look
already.
At these different
what
heroes,
the hell happened
what we tried
to
do
just stopped.
Is just
that's
we
a great
with
picture.
The basis of shooter controls, and we wanted to draw on MOBAs and strategy games and look at ways to make it a really compelling strategic back and forth.
He'll
but
be on in 45
each one
minutes.
Of these heroes gives us
oh
a
my god.
The conference will be over.
Someone just sent me to fucking Valve URL,
like
and the third box is Half-Life 3.
Really
what?
Hang
on, I'll send it to you. Nah,
no, that's bullshit. Half-Life 3 is not getting announced. Especially not a little shitty conference like this.
Well, I know that a lot of MOBAs, the heroes
it's
are
literally never going to happen because it's
literally.
Oh no, I think it'll happen.
Yeah, literally. It's never going to happen. It's been way too long since the last Half-Life. They're not going to re-release a sequel to something that's that fucking old. And don't say Shenmue, that's a...
you know,
is that real?
That's
true. That can't be real. I don't believe that.
I'm checking who is right now.
Why would it be on there?
Are much more about,
they're hiding it.
Thinking, positional thinking, so there's a character
okay.
Zelma.
There's a for people watching this on YouTube. This
really
is going up on YouTube,
the
by the way.
Itself,
there's a roulette. I guess a roulette. One of those
some of the
what is it called? Like on the web page
about,
where it has like a bunch of different things that pop up like that.
Is the Valve dot software?
Yeah, I know. But what's the thing that you see on like a web page that has that where it's like?
I don't know the name.
Whatever. Anyway, there's a leak thing that says Half-Life 3 on their web page, which is I think it's bullshit.
It may be bullshit.
Let's see. I don't think it won't not happen.
I don't think it will never happen.
You will. And if it's actually registered by Valve, then you know, each character you want
to I'm trying to find out who is fucking site that supports dot software.
I don't think it won't happen.
Yeah.
The
character that can run around and heal, sort of uses a beam scale to heal, but she can also hurt enemies and with all the characters.
If Half-Life 3 gets announced, everybody that spent their time talking about their games will be really pissed because no one will remember any of it.
No one will give a fuck.
No one will give a fuck. I could see Valve announcing something though. I could see maybe Half-Life. I mean, not Half-Life 3. I could see Left 4 Dead 3 maybe.
According to the screen, that the beta is in August.
Yeah. Yeah.
The beta is in August for Fable Legends.
It's not official.
It's not
really.
If you go on, if you do a Who is search for Valve.software, it's the name server's namecheaphosting.com. And the Who is registrant information's got Who is got protection. So yeah, that's Valve would not use Namecheap hosting, and they wouldn't put a Who is a privacy thing. They'll just use their actual office address.
We'll see. How long is this conference?
Because they're in the last one, it was 1:30.
Can you look it up? I can't. I know the stream will freeze.
Yeah, if Rod needs his space. He needs his space.
Hang on.
So, Rod, I'm going to leave this relatively open-ended. Tell us what brings you to the PC Gaming Show.
I may be announcing that Gears of War Ultimate Edition is coming
complete schedule.
To PC.
Oh, Gears of War Ultimate Edition is coming to PC.
Oh, shit. Nice.
Let's go ahead and take a look.
That's a good good fucking choice, actually. I want Gears on PC.
There you go. Well, Gears of War 1 was on PC, wasn't it?
Yeah, the first one, though.
Yeah, this is the first one.
Rebuilt, remastered from the
oh, is it a remake?
Yeah, it's a remaster.
Oh, cool.
It's 60 frames per second, 1080p.
You know, we support mouse and keyboard.
40,000 more gamer score. You get to play as Marcus Fenix and Master Chief. And the best part, you dual wield lancers this time, so you have two chainsaw guns.
Yeah, it didn't say how long it's going to last. It just says it starts at 9.
Gears 1 PC was 2007.
Could be fucking forever, like, for all we care.
It's one of those things when you have a game.
All we know, rather.
I hope it's over after this.
It's like, you know, but nostalgia is great, but when you actually go
watching this was a mistake.
I don't know. We'll see. Maybe something surprising happens.
Hold up, and you have to make it kind of more contemporary.
What were some of those? I don't know. Gears of War. I'm looking forward to it, but I'm not getting a fucking PC. Well, from the PC, I actually never completed Gears of War 1. That's the only Gears of War I never beat.
One of the things we're doing is they're taking a lot of that PC content,
but it doesn't matter,
to the console, so they get to enjoy it.
I guess.
But being able to sort of just expand on what you have in terms of, again, you know, all the different options you can get into. But from the, just an overall game perspective, the difference between the original to the way the remastered is just we rebuilt everything from the ground up. You know, we started with the core simulation, but there's over 3,000 art assets.
They rebuilt the entire first game, pretty much.
We have 19 multiplayer maps. We've got a bunch of new modes. But, you know, we looked at how do people play Gears of War multiplayer. We found that TDM was the best way to play socially, and King of the Hill was the best way to play competitively. And so we took those two modes from Gears 3 and brought them back to the Ultimate Edition so that people can play the way they want to play.
King of the Hill.
So it's things like that. There's lots of little tweaks that walk this line between nostalgia and contemporary shooter in 2015.
What about some of the other features you can take advantage of now that it's going to be on Windows 10?
Oh, well, you know, the standard stuff that comes with Windows 10, Xbox Live, Game DVR, like all the things you would expect to be able to take advantage of, Ultimate Edition will.
Well, awesome. Now, of course, are there other things in the future that the PC fans can look forward to from the Gears of War franchise?
Nothing to announce yet. That'll be something we'll be happy to talk about at a later time.
Okay. Well, great.
Hey, Ray, announce Gears of War.
Nothing to announce.
Coming out, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, Ray, announce Gears of War.
Initiative.
All right, yeah, woo. All right.
Woo.
Get the fuck off the stage. Get the fuck out.
Now, of course, this is a moment.
What?
That I was asked to do. I resisted, but if you're looking for the one moment when Dana
is wearing jeans,
stay with me.
Oh, no.
Oh, he's wearing you're fucking right.
For any of you who are familiar with a company called SCS Software, they make a game called
what
Euro
the fuck
Truck
is that
Simulator.
SCS Euro Truck Simulator.
They are expanding
no fucking
with
way.
Brand new content, and I am thrilled to be able to present to you.
That's not even an announcement.
American Truck Simulator.
That's not even, they announced
American,
it like 2 years ago.
American Truck Simulator.
Holy fucking shit.
Euro Truck Simulator is supposed to be really, really, really fucking good, if you like
it. I have fucking 300 hours in that game.
If you're in the trucking.
You like it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun.
Good game.
Yeah, I hear it's really good if you like trucks. Which I guess people like trucks.
Yes.
It's literally, you just drive, right?
Somewhere on the spectrum.
You do jobs, and then you drive and go do more jobs.
I don't...
get to deliver potatoes and shit. It's amazing.
Bunch of fucking idiots.
This looks fucking... good? Sweet.
This looks sweet. This is the future of games.
The future, right here. It's not driving, it's trucking.
Fuck yes. I can't wait, my dick is already hard. Yeah, but why does it even matter? Like, Euro Truck Simulator was on Steam
if you want
for everybody.
To join in on the drive,
it was like we couldn't play that.
San Francisco to LA to be here, you can do it in American Truck Simulator. It was actually made using Google Maps.
It was made by using Google Maps.
No woo for Google Maps? Thank you.
Stop doing
woos.
Yeah, that's
how I found here.
Okay, it's only halfway through that fucking stack.
Big elephants in the room in PC gaming.
All
right,
so we're halfway through the conference.
Everyone's excited.
Unless, like, the next four presenters are like, "Hey, what's up? How you doing? All right, bye."
It's unclear exactly.
Go home.
Get the fuck out. I need to announce Half-Life 3. Oh shit! Oops.
The man that I'm about to invite onto stage, he has some ideas with a product called Eve Valkyrie. Let's bring on to the stage Ryan Geddes from CCP. Ryan, hey!
He definitely looks like a developer for CP games.
And just...
Now, Ryan, right off the bat, I dabbled with...
Let me ask you a question, Joe. What's like looking like Steve Jobs?
Yeah, he does. I was going to say, what are you talking about? Because I'm looking at my iPad and I can turn up and I'm like, oh shit, here he is.
In your eyes,
he's back.
A more compelling natural experience for VR.
Let me ask you, what happened to your turtleneck?
We are trying to essentially
let me ask you, how's cancer?
What is the essence of space combat?
How's death?
So we are putting you right in the cockpit of a Valkyrie fighter in the EVE universe, shooting you out of a tube into space and basically just surrounding you with combat. So it's, you know, people locking onto you, missiles, machine guns, you're working as a team, you know, you're really trying to survive out there in space. So
now, yeah, and I was
this game
tried out last night and
American Truck Simulator.
This is still American Truck Simulator.
Yes.
He said something about space sim, right, so I don't know if that's true.
Oh, it might be Space Truck Simulator.
It's Space Truck Simulator. What did you say?
I threw up.
EVE, the game that came out like 7 years ago.
Oh my god, it's the Morpheus Oculus.
Get him. Kill him.
Is this Elite Dangerous?
He's cursed.
Kill him.
Yeah.
I'm cursed.
What's up, faggots?
Shit, I'm gonna fall over.
Shit, you fucking piece of shit.
Hey, god.
Fuck.
Oh my god, that is so
I've never seen anybody react to an Oculus Morpheus before. That's the first time ever.
My proudest moment.
I don't know why the fuck you play with him standing up.
And I mean, I cannot stress
I guess they couldn't afford a seat for him.
To sort of look up.
You can afford Oculus, but you can't afford fucking a seat.
So, let me get this straight. The Morpheus makes it feel like, or the Oculus, whatever the fuck that was, makes it feel like you can, like, be in there.
Yeah, I think once
and it fucks with your head.
It's fine. You can
I hope so.
I guess. I don't know. I still don't know much about Oculus and Morpheus.
Nor do I.
I don't give a shit, really.
It's owned by Oculus.
Until I get it. Then I'll be like, yeah.
It's owned by Oculus.
I know. I think Microsoft partnered up with that and the whatever the fucking Steam one is supposed to be a Steam one also. So if you buy an Oculus, it comes with an Xbox One controller.
Where your teammates are, where the enemies are,
and you can use it for Oculus, I guess.
Once you get that, you really feel like you're there. And when you take the headset,
does it come with that $150 fucking Elite controller?
No, that
immediately.
That's the price of a whole system.
Probably not poorly planned.
Why the fuck would anybody buy that?
Wait, I'm sorry. The Elite controller's a price for whole Xbox One.
The Elite one. Have you seen that one?
The Elite's $150. Yeah, I mean, first of all, so it's like half.
How the hell do they justify that? It's
because
just
it makes your coffee in the morning. It pleases you when you need it.
Make a game first and bring it over.
When you need it.
When you need it. It was about learning how to make games. It makes. Did I say it makes your coffee in the morning?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's it. That's all it does.
About finding out how does the UI
and
work,
also you can control your games.
Like, you don't want to be looking
also, you can move.
It fucks you in the ass for
yeah, and it fucks you in your butt.
Do simple menus.
If you're into that.
I like that they announced it. Everybody's like, oh, cool, a new controller. That's the same price as the old one, right? Nope. $100 more.
More than double.
Triple almost. I think the Xbox One controller is like, what, 50 or 60?
$59.99 as far as I know.
To be really in the moment with you.
Phil Spence just leans.
You always see them on sale, though. Always on sale for like 45 or 40.
Right. What'd you say, Christian?
Just Phil Spencer leans over and says, what, you poor?
What, you poor, bitch?
Since it's got different D-pad on it, you're not going to spend $150 on that? Come on.
Oh, I did that.
Get out of my face.
What you going to do? Buy your bullshit ass Bloodborne games? Pussy. Should buy a real controller for a real console and be a real man, you fucking real piece of shit.
We are obviously
I'm Phil Spencer.
Very
the Phil is for filling your mom up with my jizz. Oh, okay, oh man, I fucked your mom. I mean,
we
and your dad.
I mean, you know, at CCP for a long time.
I don't care.
You can tell he works for the Xbox Live division.
Phil Spencer. And what is this again? Is this Halo?
Yeah, might as well be.
Halo's on PC now. There's the
Halo Online now.
Wait, hold on. Look at the ball. That's the bad guy from Halo 4. The testicle.
Yeah.
That's the dick deck.
Sort of combine this with the EVE experience.
Is it Star Fox?
We see EVE Online.
This is Star Fox if Nintendo had a budget.
I mean, this game is really all about. You know, getting you into the cockpit, getting you out, getting you into combat. It's multiplayer.
Is it EVE Online?
You know,
space. Or Valkyrie?
Yeah.
This is actually the next Magic the Gathering game.
Intense moments, as anybody who's been
I believe it.
Gate camped knows.
So, I'm assuming it's EVE Valkyrie because it says that on his shirt.
The corporation.
Right.
Unless he stole that from the EVE Valkyrie guys.
It's really about the thrill and the intensity of combat. And for any of you who have not gotten the chance to try it, I strongly recommend you give it a shot. It is.
You strongly Mexican? Is that about?
Insane, intense.
Was he just about to say that?
I can't wait to see it.
I am strongly Mexican.
Thanks for coming out.
All right, thanks, okay, man. Thank you for being the last one on my cue card. Oh wait.
Our next guest is one of the creators of a game called DayZ.
Oh. Jay-Z.
Oh, revered. He worked on DayZ for quite a while before departing to create his own studio project. So please join me in welcoming Dean Hall from RocketWorks. Dean!
Dean! It's Dean!
Welcome to the show, Dean. Now, Dean, I want to start right away
Dean
by
Hall.
Talking about early access. You're one of the people with
Dean,
the
welcome, Dean.
Shitty with Dean. Early access. What do you feel like the status of it is right now?
Well, I guess they have a Jet Set shirt on.
Feelings in some ways, like
I can't tell.
Like
no,
Space
London
Program,
something.
Prison Architect. But it's, it
all right.
Also
so this game is he showed this at the Sony press conference.
I mean, I think.
It was Microsoft's one. But,
is it
Microsoft? It was one where, yeah, we saw like some naked like guy and
space.
Space, yeah, that was it.
All right, so this is what the A-Team space game so far this conference.
Now that seems sort of paradoxical.
We had that one was a Starship civilian or whatever, and then that whatever the fuck we just saw, and now this. That's three, but I'm gonna say A-Team because.
But if your game gets really popular and you're continually redefining your scope, then you kind of
makes
lose
it sadder when
roadmap.
I have to watch more
and
of this shit.
I think that's why I feel the roadmap's super important.
Yeah, and what exactly would that constitute? Like, if you were working on another early access project, how would you want to...
Well, that's very important.
Well, I played a game called Neo Scavenger, and people know it. It's a PC gamer, so... I had a really great roadmap.
Oh, cool.
Told you, like, what stuff was completed, and I think that...
Well, take the upcoming Super Mario Maker game on Wii U for a spin before it's released during this special demo event. Receive a free limited edition Super Mario Bros. 30th Anniversary button.
I want to know what...
My local Best Buy has one.
Cool, do it.
Well, I think,
probably will.
Yeah, they announced that during the conference.
A great game is more about what you don't put in than what you do. So, I guess...
All right, they're actually showing something of this game now?
No, this is the same trailer of the Xbox show.
Oh, it's so memorable.
We wanted to
see the exact same one.
Oh, good. Let me show you exactly the same thing, and let me my boring monotone bullshit voice tell you what's going on. All right, so this is Space. You might have heard of it. All right, we're moving.
You.
Here's
a
guy.
Thing, if you look up in the, if you tilt your head up a bit, you might be able to see it.
Yeah, make sure you go out at night because you can see it a little bit better.
Yeah,
you can see like lights. Those are called stars.
It sort of hints to the gameplay, but if I open up,
you might see a little guy floating in a plastic bag.
Moving slightly.
Yeah, he looks like E.T. if he was skinny and hot.
It's like to be a pioneer and go around
and hot.
Stations.
And
so
hot.
We're sort of
that guy's pretty hot.
And then allowing players
I love
coming soon lasted like 0.5 seconds.
I love a newly born man.
We
tell you,
trying to hide
get
that
back from that first person view and actually get back into that Diablo style view. So it becomes more about what you're doing in the game.
So is it not a 3D environment or is it like 2D?
It is
like a Z.
No, it's
plane?
A 3D environment.
Oh, it's a 3D environment. That's interesting.
He's trying
to ask that question if he like shown some fucking gameplay.
Well, because the game's not even made like not even.
That was a goes fucking 2D.
What's before alpha? Is it besides pre-alpha? Not pre-alpha. What's that? What's before pre-alpha?
Nothing.
Nothing. That's what that's what's up now.
I didn't though. Like, yeah.
He's all like, I'm an ideas guy.
Now you can mute them. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Please tweet at me at Dane9TV. Now. Well, I'm curious how with
what did he say?
Stigma,
did he say something funny? I don't care.
Something about muting people on Twitter.
Let me tweet him on Twitter. What was it?
A lot of it comes down to...
I don't know, some shit. He was saying, if someone talks shit about the game, he's going to block them, but he was joking.
What is it? Let me see. He said Dan TV, right?
I mean, it was a mod that I thought...
I hope it's this guy. I'm about to tell him to fuck off.
But
actually, let me say something nicer.
And
when
I first look at what to do, I realized I didn't have the resources, and so I sold it to
dead
the engineer, who I knew had the ability.
Yeah, when is your mic coming, really? When's that happening?
I stayed a lot longer than I originally intended.
Oh, somebody in my chat.
Ion is an example of a game that I've always wanted to make.
I have a chat.
Where? It's a challenge, and I think really it's now about
the fuck was that?
Why do you have a chat?
I have learned.
Why do I have a chat? I
mean, that, yeah, we deliver on stuff.
So, oh shit, you're streaming this.
I'm yeah.
Are you streaming too?
Fucking night. Okay.
Both
I know go on you go, boss, but
yeah, I don't know you're streaming. What the
well,
fuck?
Well, we're showing very little at
the moment. Yeah, but
not be like, I better not be like well, not racist sure. or anything. People
really
are actually watching your stream.
Oh, that's not funny.
Yeah, people don't watch my shit. Game.
We need to have more.
No one
gives
a fuck
about me. No one watches mine unless I watch a movie. Besieged? No one cares about
yeah,
games.
Look at that. It's good.
Redog said pre-alpha is before pre-alpha.
Shit, that's what it is.
Post pre-alpha.
We don't have an I just want on your channel, I like how you speedrun the trailer part of GTA 5, you know, the worst bit of the game that you'd want to get finished as soon as possible.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck Trevor. Ruined the game.
Trevor's good.
He's a meme character.
Trevor is a meme. That's, you're not wrong. When GTA 6.
Yeah, so
is that announcing tonight for PC?
What?
Couldn't do anything.
At the coveted PC gaming show.
If a kidney falls out, you're actually okay. You have another kidney, right?
That's right, yeah. Although all your organs
fell out.
Oh,
he gets my tweet.
So you have realistic organ simulation?
Yeah,
in
yeah. Mm. But, technology.
You only hear about eventual revenge ring out. Heavyweight runs. I haven't done that in a while. Uh-huh.
They've made this amazing technology.
I'm reading your calls on your Twitch stream now. Do you want to play some GTA Online? Really been able to allow
us to slow down on the fuck. No.
Well, you've teased a lot of cool ideas. I look forward to it.
Yeah, you teased a lot of cool ideas. Why don't you get off the stage and let us see other ideas that are actually visual?
I'm going to step around my chair in the unusual suitcase brought from AMD that I'm not entirely sure what's inside. Because this is now a time to halt talking and do the first live demo on stage.
Oh, live demo.
Yes, thank you.
Oh boy.
For buying into that. The game is going to be one that you may have seen on Kickstarter that had one of the best Kickstarter videos of all time. It's a game called Strafe. Please join me in welcoming from Pixel Titans.
One of the best Glunt and Kickstarter Steven games of all time. That's right.
I'd like to give a special
shout out. No, he said one of the best Kickstarter trailers of all time.
I'd like to give a shout out to this guy doing the fucking suit and fucking jeans combo here. We pointed this out earlier, but what the fuck?
Oh, yeah, I didn't even notice. Paying homage to the what? Community loved in our he didn't think he'd have to get up ever. I tell there's no crying.
Yeah. Should at least worn black jeans. I mean, like,
he's just like, oh, no one's watching. It's a fucking PC gaming show. Come on.
Has a procedurally generated component
to it. So in terms of the environment, we're going to be talking to Tripwire guys. No one's going to be watching this.
This game looks like 2016. Let me say.
Look, if the developer Pixel Strife,
huh?
Kind
of, you
know, their audio is fucked. They finally got their mic in now.
The developers of Pixel Strife obviously didn't put any effort into the making their game. He's not going to put any effort into like dressing nice for them, is he?
Why would
this looks like a piece of shit?
Well, I think it's supposed to look blocky. I think that's the point. I can't remember what this game's about. I did see the trailer. The trailer was pretty good, actually.
Say like, oh, it's supposed to look blocky. It's like saying like, oh, I was merely pretending to be retarded. So it makes it okay.
Christian's so cynical.
Men in Black for the PS1.
Jesus Christ. We have a lot of you should switch your website name to Cynical Cast. And just through playing them again and again and again, we're able to find the things we like and we don't like and just work. Is there any games you really like besides Euro Truck Simulator? Are they?
Me?
No, Christian.
No, I don't like games. Fuck video games.
All right,
I've
Sam.
Never liked games.
Oh, yeah. Well, you
Fallout has too many voices in it.
Some of these enemies are brand new. Wait, do you believe that too?
They all have different behaviors. Oh, that's a fucking stupid opinion. Why wouldn't you want dialogue?
Also, Sony going bankrupt.
Yeah, Sony's gonna go bankrupt in 10 years.
I gotta say, I love the
because movie sucked. Spider-Man
yeah,
ruined them.
Especially started out the movie bit—the bit that makes him the most money.
The Sony, yeah, Sony's done. Fucking Spider-Man ruined them. He only made $1 jillion. I literally can't think of any other Sony movies from the last year. You know, things
that can like my dog on in your chat, Matt, is like dead on. This is literally just a Kickstarter showcase.
Yep.
So far. I mean, besides maybe Fable Legends, it's about
it's been Kickstarter or stuff that was already shown in the Microsoft conference
stuff
with nothing
already
added
about.
To it. With, you know, Yeah.
Half-Life 3 needs a Kickstarter.
Half-Life 3 does need a Kickstarter. So that Valve actually knows people give a fuck. A different type of weapon
with the rocket launcher turned into a baseball. Gabe Newell doesn't know what he's doing.
So this is a gun that we're
he'll probably announce Team Fortress 3 before he announced Half-Life 3.
So when my fucking Left 4 Dead 3, Team Fortress 3, and Portal 3 all on the same night before they announced Half-Life 3.
And that's a joke because I think he said Half-Life. I mean Half-Life. Team Fortress 2 will never happen. You level them up, you kind of because he just wants to keep like working on Team Fortress 2 forever. You kind
of always default back to those, but there'll be plenty of things for you to just like constantly evolving.
Yeah. Of course, I gotta know, what is the sort of expected gameplay loop like when you sit down to play?
Well, you jump in, you...
I like how you asked that question to the developer and he wasn't even looking at him.
I like that this looks like pre-alpha footage of the new Doom game.
Clean and elegant. You should hang out with Tripwire.
Love those guys.
Thank you for showing your student project here, but really, where's the real game? Oh, that's it.
Oh. Is Killing Floor 2 a Kickstarter?
No.
Was Killing Floor 1 a Kickstarter?
Setting up the next game for us. Okay. Well, Kickstarter wasn't around when Killing Floor 1 came out.
Now,
if it was, it wasn't popular.
I grew up playing in the form of things such as Fallout 1 and 2.
Fallout 4?
And the fact that there's a renaissance of these classic RPGs has me so excited, has me tickled, which is why it is my absolute pleasure to announce the upcoming expansion to Pillars of Eternity, The White March.
What the fuck? Pillars of Eternity. I heard that game's great.
What the fuck is Pillars of Eternity?
Look it up. It's supposed to be like a old school style, like isometric RPG dungeon crawler.
Oh, 1 buck. Turbos, dude. Fucking nice.
Huh?
Apparently, if you spend $1 on Humble Bundle, you can get a Twitch Turbo for 3 months.
Oh, yeah, holy shit. Oh, it's 30 days, but still.
That was 30 days this time. It was 90 last time.
It comes with Wildstar as well.
Well, it's free to play, so.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, when did that go free to play?
Well, they announced it like a month ago, so I'm assuming it went through now. Which I'm pissed because I bought that game when it came out. And now.
It's apparently like pretty damn good, though.
I think you still need to buy the game, so.
Cool. Yeah. Yeah, that's, I mean, like, damn, I wanted to give it a try, so.
So you still need to buy the game, but you can.
Obsidian and Paradox. Yeah,
you can play it for free, no subscription.
Thanks, Rydog. Thank you. Even though you weren't talking to me, you were talking to Matt, but still.
Well, there needs to be
what do you say?
He just gave the heads up.
Own bottle thing.
Yeah. Now, of course, simple question.
Yes.
Tell us about the White March.
Well, the White March is the first part of the expansion we're doing for Eternity.
Yeah, I'm going to get one.
It's a whole lot more Eternity. I mean, we've been making RPGs for years, and the funnest thing about doing expansions is you get
to just
add more, and we're doing more companions. We're doing Soulbound
weapons. Oh, this fall will be free.
Cap. We're doing a ton of stuff, and of course, you know, what we're really known for a lot is all of the dialogue and the writing, and we're doing even more than we did for the main game.
And, you know, I know that Pillars of Eternity was kickstarted for $1 million, and now you're teaming up with Paradox. Friend, talk to me a little bit about your partnership.
Well, we've known
Payday 2 on PC for if you beat the average as well.
Too well sometimes.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, sometimes too well. We can sit for hours and discuss whether
$6.
A great movie or Clean Out Terrible. and that's great. So
that was such a jab to put in there. I love that.
So
when
the opportunity came up to work with Obsidian,
that's great.
We just said it's perfect because we want to work
that's
long
great.
With our partners.
Wow. What are they talking about? I don't care.
Some dumb movie.
Are they talking about a movie? So it
was a yeah, they're talking about Highlander. I'm literally around to go to a bad movie.
Paradox, who had been who?
Highlander.
Yeah. And I think, you know, the big thing about, I think what's great about...
What, in the stream?
Paradox. I mean,
yeah. He was just saying something about
games. They love...
He was saying, like, oh, we're best friends. And talk about what a Highlander is good for that movie.
And so when it's it's great
all the time. Kind
of stupid assholes is a great movie.
Games published and being able to work with people.
Is the average $3.99?
Like it's not these giant console games, which are great, but it's great that we can now offer.
Oh no! Why don't you type a little bit louder? Maybe it'll tell you,
Christian.
Hard to do. Oh, sorry, what?
I mean, I know that
is the average $3.99?
Is what $3.99?
The average $3.99.
$3.99. Oh,
yeah.
projects after yeah, it is, but to get Payday, you need the average plus $2. Yeah. But, you know,
with, I think I might have got Payday at some point. Balance that with the community expectations as well
as wanting to make a good game? Well, I think, first of all, we're old, you know, and so we've been doing
so bored.
So we do this for a while, right? And we and particularly back at Black Isle Studios, you know, we worked on Planescape Torment, we worked on Icewind Dale.
Woo!
We worked
Planescape Torment!
All I'm really responsible for is the combat, and the combat wasn't that great. So, but we really learned how to make those games. We always wanted to continue to make those games, and so when we got the 4 million, and then we actually got another million between when the game kickstarted and kind of towards launch. And so, you know, for about five and ended up being our budget was about 5.5 million. So we were able to do it. Yeah, really close to kind of what we got out of Kickstarter.
And I mean, from a publisher's perspective, I mean, what are your thoughts on the way Kickstarter is now changing the market?
Wow.
Yeah, Kickstarter,
this will be the last
foremost,
PC gaming show yet.
Ourselves to do a Kickstarter.
Yeah, well.
And the most obvious reason for that is that you set expectations for the project very early, and everyone who's been for a few years in the games industry,
PC games dead, guys. This killed it.
Can confirm.
Game that reaches the market X months
later. I'm gonna sell my PC right now.
That has been something that kept us away from it. But when we started talking to Obsidian about Pillars of Eternity, they were already so far ahead in development that we could see this is going to be the final product. And these guys have been making games for.
Pillars of Eternity is a good game, I heard. But I don't want to hear these three fucking nerds talk about it. I want
to
see some.
Is it trying to balance the vision against what you're presenting?
It's like a talk show.
About, you know, if that vision does change,
it's a talk show.
Will I feel comfortable communicating that?
Or I think that's obviously what they're actually going for. It's just a shame they didn't fucking inform anybody before it started.
Yeah,
for real. Not have been interested and skipped it.
Really only do 6 classes, now let's do 11. You know, and so, and a lot of that is in the excitement of the Kickstarter, you can offer a little.
Are you my dad? Yeah, I am.
To an extent. But in the end, I am now. I think what we did a great job with Eternity, and what I'm proud of, is really that.
Matt's your weekend, Dad.
And make the successor to the Baldur's Gate.
It's not even the weekend yet.
We did, and we are super grateful to all our backers that let us do it.
I'm super excited to see the white mark soon, guys.
Awesome! Everybody's clapped those turbo icons now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hopefully, the next game is the end game.
How are you guys enjoying yourselves tonight?
So far, I hate this. Woo!
Apparently, next game's the end game, or like the host just shoots himself on stage, or what?
He's a legendary creator.
All right, guys, because there's supposed to be something in the suitcase, it'll just be a shotgun. All right, let me show you how Kurt Cobain went out.
Where is it?
Frontier Developments.
We're in a real golden age of PC gaming, and we at Frontier are proud to be a part of it.
Did you just say there's going to be a demo or something like that?
Great updates to the game.
Yeah, they showed a live demo.
Since launch.
Did they? I don't even remember. When was that?
Yeah, was that shitty game?
Oh, yeah.
Oh my god, he's playing a Michael Bay!
Sorry.
Woo! Yeah!
Wow.
That's just the start.
He fucking pulled a Michael Bay.
There is so much to come on PC.
Well, no, he didn't leave the stage, though.
To announce soon.
He's just like, sorry, I'm waiting for the stupid ass bullshit to fucking load.
A little different. It's a game we wanted to make for a long time. Another game we wanted to make for a long time.
Half-Life 2.
It's the revival of a great genre.
Half-Life 2.
And it's coming to PC in 2016.
This studio is like 3 miles away from where I live.
It's available for pre-order now on the Frontier store.
Just like Sunset Fair.
And this is what it looks like.
What a nervous fuck. Oh my god! Is this King's Quest?
We're all exclusive.
No. What the fuck is this?
This kind of shit.
Well, it's supposed to be an old franchise.
The Sims.
Oh.
Old, yeah.
It is, bro. To be fair, it is. But Frontier didn't think of making much sense.
Maybe Frontier is Maxis. In
Wait.
Disguise.
Oh,
there
shit.
We go. I got Payday 2 Game of the Year. 2 codes. Just sitting here in a text file.
Nice.
So I don't think I need that.
Oh, it's fucking Roller Coaster.
Oh shit, is it Roller Coaster Tycoon?
Holy shit, finally.
It's
Atari who owns the rights to it, but Frontier made it. So I don't know if this is like a spiritual successor.
Yeah, I don't care. I love Roller Coaster Tycoon. I love Roller Coaster Tycoon.
Holy shit.
This is a good ass trailer now.
Yeah, this is good. Now I know what the hell's going on.
Planet Coaster. Okay, well, whatever. Fine.
Sure.
Thank you so much, David. That's a very different tone from Elite Dangerous. It looks lovely. Now we have a very
I like how that guy, like, got a plane 5,000 miles away just to, like, go, hey guys, so here's a trailer, bye.
Yeah, he did nervously.
Heart of Thorns, Colin
Johansson. I'm sure shoot himself on stage and say a sentence and then bugger off.
That looked good though. I want to play that.
Yeah. I mean, they can't fuck it up. I mean, they're the ones who made the, Coaster Tycoon in the first place.
Yes. Yeah. So I'm
who
here
made
today
City
to,
Skyline?
Reveal a world exclusive, our Guildhall's feature.
What?
Who made City Skyline?
Heart of Thorns. The people who made Cities in Motion.
Okay.
Creating opportunities to bring players together. That's why we make games. Hundreds of
thanks
players playing around in maps.
You're welcome.
Yes, let's not keep them separated.
We made Fallout 4, guys. I made Fallout 3.
Players that we're bringing
yeah
together. That
thank you.
Truly meaningful impact on our world.
Now I
know. That's all say. Thanks.
And I brought a world exclusive trailer here today.
Oh, world exclusive. All right, now we're getting to interesting shit. Kinda. Arena
world
net
exclusive.
Oh, I don't care. Never mind. Yeah, world exclusive. Just tell us what it is in the first frame.
That that's good shit.
Cool. Guild Wars 2, the Guild Wars of Wars.
Very good.
Claim your guild hall. I don't want to. I heard Guild Wars 2 is great. I even bought it a long time ago when it was like $20. Never played it.
Pretty good.
Damn, man, what are you
Christian
typing?
Going hard. That ain't even me. That's Christian.
God damn. Yeah,
my name. I have a setup mic.
Holy fuck.
Well, boy, if you went like poor, you would have a mechanical keyboard as well, like me and Matt.
No, I just have a really good mic that doesn't pick up bullshit-ass mechanical key presses. I gotta afford a mic that sounds like sex.
Okay.
That's an American
if,
term.
If you say so.
That's an American term. You don't know. That means great.
So, oh, so, an American
so,
term.
So when you're, when you're writing your thesis and you want to explain how something's good, you use sex. Because sex is never bad. There you go. Teaching the little children of the world something.
I can teach you a British saying, which means something that's good. The dog's bollocks. There you go.
Yeah, well, you're a cunt.
It's not in your faces.
You're a cunt. That's like the letter A over there, right? You use it so much.
Yeah. How do you think about Australia?
Oh, whatever. Same place.
Yeah.
I'm so bored with this trailer. I'm literally thinking of other trailers that could exist.
I'm literally thinking of suicide. I'm so bored.
While I'm talking about cunts, I'm thinking of other things that I could think about. Heart of Thorns. What a cool subtitle. I can't wait to not fucking play this.
You know, this still makes me laugh because you describe Guildhall.
That shadow makes it, that guy in the shorts look like he pissed himself.
Yeah, he did actually. the piss stain wasn't there before the trailer started.
They are an entire map that your guild gets to own.
Just couldn't contain himself. Fucking love Guild Wars.
He fucking loves Gears of
Guild Wars. Fucking love Guild Wars too.
I love Gears of War.
Fight their way into the jungle, and they'll actually fight their way through this hall to capture the map for their guild. Once they own it, it becomes basically their home to customize, personalize, grow, and develop.
God, I could murder us up right now.
Oh my god, is this conference over?
You can form guild teams,
is my life over?
And from here,
hey, it's just not going to end.
You can compete in the competitive PvP.
Oh my god. This is going to be the longest conference. Which is a new and the
like
most
I get kicked out of the fucking
you can go on guild missions
room.
Guild portal. Where it opens up
I'm sure there's a bunch of PC fucktards that love this, but
complete guild puzzles, go on guild treks, guild races,
I mean,
within the guild hall itself, you can build all these different world exclusive as well as your guild progresses.
World exclusive.
There's so much customization in here and fun for guilds to have.
It's not really much of an exclusive when it's only exclusive because no one else wanted to cover it.
Half-Life 3 confirmed.
There's a ton. I'll tell you about what some of these buildings are that we're looking at right now. For example, this first one.
He just like mentions like, oh, and Half-Life 3, we did have a trailer for that, but we don't have any time to show it or talk about it. So we got to go straight to Guild Wars 2.
We lost the Valve sent us a USB thumb drive. We lost it. Sorry.
And you can even change the
so Half-Life 3 not confirmed.
While people are in there fighting against each other to change up the experience. Another one of the buildings that you can build is the workshop. And the workshop is a place where we're adding an entirely new guild-specific crafting profession, items for all the people in your guild. And within there as well, you can build items that they can take out in the world.
This is like the 7th conference.
Well, this was a very
easy. I feel like I've heard this exact same shit from
my
WoW.
Host, Colin, yay!
The exact same.
Now, I mean, what are some of this that we're seeing right now on screen with this assault on this castle?
Yeah, so one of the really cool buildings that you can build in your guild hall is actually the War Room. And the War Room allows you to build tools that you can take into our epic hundreds of players world versus world PvP. And you can use these tools and take them with your guild. Claim objectives.
Our epic hundreds of players. Because that way people play Guild Wars.
Objectives in World versus World. So, for example, here, this
a lot of people do play Guild Wars too.
They're actually able to
call
in a lot of fat nerds with no friends.
Defend the castle and bombard it as long as the guild is able to hold it.
Bunch of fucking idiots. You play fucking Guild Wars too? You're a goddamn idiot.
Well, you know, honestly, Colin, I'm just gonna.
You should get the fuck out.
Who even plays video games? Jesus.
I mean, stop asking him questions. You're encouraging him. Jesus.
I find MMOs to be such a difficult to develop for because people just rip through the content so quickly. And this just looks like
maybe the host just feels like pity on him. Like, no one actually cares about Guild Wars, but I'll hear him for 10 minutes.
That is, very soon, we're going to be turning on pre-sales for Guild Wars 2 Heart of Thorns. And just like before the release of Guild Wars 2, pre-purchasing will guarantee you access to all of our open beta events.
That's huge.
And how soon's very soon?
We are starting pre-purchase right now. So you can go to the guildwars2.com website.
God, the audience looks so fucking bored as well.
Well, Colin,
right
thank
now.
You for making this segment extremely easy for me.
Absolutely, yeah. We hope to see everybody in our pre-purchase soon.
Colin Johansson from ArenaNet. Thank you, Colin.
I'm acting like the cameraman. I'm so bored.
Well, nice. Coming up next is yet another PC franchise that I am amazed is 15 years old. It is an upcoming game called...
This has only been going on for an hour and 20 minutes. It feels like it's been going on for a lot longer.
IO Interactive.
Feels like I've been watching this for like 3 hours.
Hitman.
Oh, Hitman! Oh. Oh.
A noble battle.
Now,
right away, I have to ask, okay. How long have you been working on the Hitman franchise?
Oh, it's 47 himself. There he is.
Yeah.
There he is. He's bald. I can't hear you.
10 years.
The mic doesn't work.
When you're in this place, are you just imagining exit routes and who do you need to eavesdrop on?
Yeah, it's almost like someone.
Can you guys hear him or is
no? Yeah, his mic's fucked.
I like that the
what?
I like that. I wish those was like what?
Upcoming game.
What?
Speak up! You're talking too low.
It very much so looked like Hitman stepping into the digital age, because I mean, when Hitman first came out, so many of the technologies we use day to day aren't even present.
The animal Batista.
Okay, finally get some inches, and we can't hear the motherfucker even talk.
15 years.
What?
I hear people coughing in the background more.
Yeah.
Well, so, I mean, what we're getting the chance to see here is...
Someone yelled out microphone.
Microphone.
What? What did he say?
Well, I mean, right now, we're seeing some of this footage that's on...
No, yeah, but what was the question?
Absolutely.
Oh, he said microphone, and they said, can't hear me now.
Talk to me a little bit more about that. The gameplay is... taking the sort of sandbox nature of these missions.
Oh wow, just like the original Hitman games.
Well, that sounded like a working mic.
Just loop the fucking... Just loop the goddamn trailer.
Make it go slow.
I'm trying to take this and... Can I just borrow your mic? Yeah, here, you know what? No, come here, come here. Lean close.
Oh, he's gonna do the same thing he did with Kevin Pereira.
Please. Embrace me warmly.
Come over here, talking to my mic. Make out with me.
Yeah, Kevin Pereira did that at the Nintendo World Championship.
My ear.
I'll never let you go.
So what you're seeing there, footage is it's Paris.
Whisper
the
hits.
It's a location called Paris, and you're in there to take out a target called...
They're actually doing this.
Yeah, they did that during the Nintendo World Championship.
The locations we have here are the biggest we've ever...
He could have just took his headset off and just...
To the older
it should take hands.
Well, no, then now they can both talk.
A lot more NPCs in there, a lot more complex, deep, high-definition sandboxes.
Oh my god, they're only halfway through the cue cards?
You talked to me before about the idea of...
Yeah.
Is this really 3 hours long?
If you expand upon them, I mean, like, right now, for instance, we're at this fashion show.
Suck my dick.
So Hitman is, you know, a new bold...
Jesus Christ.
Before, we've been working years on a game...
The next 10 better be just him, like, there, right? Saying, like, hey, Mountain Dew, right? Gatorade, thanks for all the fucking sponsors.
And some other things,
or some shit.
Right.
So what we're doing right now, we are
it's better be fucking worth it.
8th of December, digital launch, where we'll have the opportunity...
I forgot this comes out December.
...deepen and expand the
that's really cool. 7th or 8th.
8th, I think. 4th is Xenoblade, and then the first is...
With the gamers and community shit. To get input to, you know, tweak the
damn,
features.
What's December 1st?
But also... Make sure that the content that will evolve and come later will be the best possible Hitman experience for them.
And I want to come back to something you said earlier where...
Oh my god, this looks so much like Hitman.
Simulations that you could run.
It's almost like it
so
is.
So much larger. What does that sort of specifically entail?
Right, so compared to the levels we've been doing before...
But I'm going to have to leave before I kill myself, because Jesus Christ.
Hitman is...
No, don't leave.
That we have from...
It'll be over in 300 hours.
From Map Solution.
It'll be over soon. It'll be over soon.
Yeah, I think the rest of the key cards are bullshit. It'll be over soon.
6-7 times bigger locations. No checkpoints.
30 minutes or so.
It's really the ultimate.
Can't fucking wait 30 minutes.
They keep showing this fucking footage of just
extra NPCs and characters.
Of just the girls going back and forth.
One of the things that I always note about.
Can we just see some goddamn gameplay?
Yeah, they showed gameplay earlier. Just show the same gameplay.
Can we see some more?
I'd rather see the gameplay they showed before.
So this is bullshit. I don't know about you, but I'd rather watch this runaway repeatedly.
Wait, did they show gameplay before, right?
Yeah.
For like 15 seconds. Compared to the 2 minutes it was on.
YouTube being posted up with gamers bragging about, found a new creative way of taking out the target, right?
Yeah.
With Absolution, we introduced contracts. So once you're done with the targets in the campaign and the story, you can play contracts, play to create, right? You can use the sandbox, use the richness in it, and mechanics and the NPCs, and mark your own targets, share that with your friends, compete with your friends and the community. Now, just going from the prior games to Hitman, just imagine, you know, we're going from 55 NPCs to over 300, put the crowd on top of that, and the sheer size of checkpoint-less locations we deliver here. It's just amazing how deep and complex contracts that you can create.
Well, I mean, I have two things to say. For one, I mean, the graphics look absolutely beautiful. December 8th, you said, was the release?
Exactly.
December 8th, looking forward to the date. And of course, you smell amazing. Aww. Thank you, Hakan. For coming out.
You
smell fantastic.
Smell
now,
like
of course,
ass and body
the technology
over.
That is helping... Oh. The technology that is helping make this possible, we talked about a little bit earlier in the show. And I'm thrilled to have the chance to bring on right now the CEO of AMD, Lisa Su.
Fuck me. We're going to have another 20-minute conversation about goddamn bullshit.
Lisa,
well, let me tell you, the fucking AMD graphics card is going to make everything look amazing.
I am doing just wonderfully. Now,
is this AMD? All AMD? It's not NVIDIA.
It's AMD Presents.
The sort of benchmarks you're trying to hit, the goals you're trying to make to deliver the best.
Boy. Might as well be watching an Apple iPod
but, you know, you
fucking stupid ass conference.
People on the show today. And
right?
Just,
right?
Is it amazing?
Yes. Hey!
That's really glad you enjoy it.
And I mean, it says something about where PC gaming is.
Sorry, I don't speak Mandarin.
For, you know, for us at AMD, it's about how do we enable those experiences. Hi,
Kai Ya Ching Ya Ya.
Wonderful game.
That's Mandarin.
It's all about 4K. It's all about enabling that experience.
That's worse than what I said, Bill.
No, I'm trying to do Mandarin.
So for us, it's.
I didn't go Ching Cheng Chong.
Key technologies that will enable that game.
I actually tried to do the accent.
Well, now you have.
Well, yeah, but that wasn't jokingly. That was just like an example of how I could have been racist.
On, you know, single player experiences. How do you,
that was affectionate racism.
Yeah, what I did with the Mandarin was affectionate racism.
There's so many gamers out there.
Where I actually tried.
Came from a place of love.
Yeah, I love Mandarin people.
Richard talked about some of our new technology. We've had an incredibly busy day today, Sean. Incredibly busy. Yeah. We launched 9 new cards.
Oh my God. 9 new cards?
That I see hiding behind you.
Ooh.
Wow.
What is that?
Hiding,
you know,
yeah, my ass.
A couple
hiding.
Cards that I'm going to tell you about. Can I tell you about a couple of them?
Lisa, I would love it if you told me about a couple cards.
All right. Well, that's what I'm going to do then.
Let's do it.
Tell me about the couple cards.
Our flagship that we launched was the Radeon R9 Fury X. This is the first card with high bandwidth memory.
I need to do some jumping jacks or something. I'm falling
and
asleep.
It's a beautiful card. Actually, you have two of them in your gaming conference. Rig right over there. So,
so fucking
this card
boring.
Has incredible performance at 4K, completely designed for DX12. And when you think about VR experiences,
I've got to start fucking paying my electric bill
now.
Fucking 300 watts.
Now, we have a few others.
You gonna pay my second AMD?
Because, you know, we usually think
I hope they do,
because
I'm getting kicked out of my apartment.
Well, with high bandwidth,
I haven't paid in 4 months. Please help me, AMD.
You can really do all kinds of neat things. So this is
our
newest Radeon R9 Nano. This is the fastest graphics card for 4K.
Oh,
the smallest
it's tiny.
Factor.
So fast.
Look at this. 6 inches long.
Is it?
Just like my weenie.
Do I, do I get to
be careful touching it. It's like 200 degrees. Come on, it's AMD.
Okay.
It's never been in a computer before.
His
but
hands, his hands sets a flame right
really
in there.
It just burns right into
and
him.
So, yeah, sometimes you're going to want to build big gaming rigs. Sometimes you're going to want to build living room systems.
I am now grabbing his card.
He and that AMD card become one.
And I know that you brought some unannounced stuff today.
We do have.
I'm wondering if I finally get to know
that's
about
pretty neat, though.
Finally.
You might have a.
Ooh, announced.
You have a briefcase
I have this
over there?
Case.
Oh, the briefcase.
Here. Is that okay?
Sean, you dropped my case on your.
He's
on
cashing
your
his contract right here. Tonight.
Well, I don't know what's okay.
This guy really wants to be Jimmy Fallon.
Something on stage so that I can demonstrate.
He does look like Jimmy Fallon.
He acts like him, too.
Yeah.
Why would anybody want to be Jimmy Fallon? He's shit.
I like Jimmy Fallon when I'm not watching him
Hitman
and I'm not looking
game.
At him at all. What the fuck?
What is this?
So, AMD is about innovation. And when you think about
why did he come up?
How can I take the technology that we've described in hardware to really build a different type of system?
What is
so
this
system is actually a 16 teraflop gaming system.
Two
of our new Fiji.
Are you fucking kidding?
Now, if you think about
teraflop.
It, this is a beautiful
that sounds
app.
Like
everything
all right.
That was very good, Sean.
Thank you. I'm very happy.
And then we have a very elegant cooling system here, but if you think about the power in here, I said there were 2 Radeon R9 Fury X's in that machine. There are 2 Fiji GPUs in this machine.
Whoa.
So don't touch it gets extremely hot.
Yeah, you could grill a burger on that shit.
Some beautiful VR demos upstairs. Why don't we open
Dave, you need a portable heater?
I'm a little scared because I don't know if I broke it. But
best in town.
I'm sure you did okay. Let's take a look.
It's a fuck. Are you sure you want to open the case of that thing?
The box.
It's fire.
It's literally glowing. And it is something I could have broken.
It's Gabe Newell.
What is it?
I'll be a son of a bitch.
We wanted to save something for the PC.
Gabe Newell pops out of the suitcase.
Very
Half-Life 3 confirmed.
We are showing a dual Fiji GPU card.
Wait, hold on. Stand up. Come on, that's a big deal.
Wow.
Stand up. Come on, man. Dual Fiji water bottle.
And it tells you what the technology is capable of for PC gaming.
And I understand that these are upstairs right there right now for people to play with?
They're absolutely upstairs right there right now in Club AMD.
So they're up there in Club AMD. They're high off their tits.
The main message I wanted to
copious amounts of ecstasy and coke.
Yeah, they're playing with the AMD card right now. And when I mean that, I mean they're in the middle of a fire. Because the shit got too hot.
It's on one graphics card.
Meaning they're right now searching for a fire extinguisher because the thing went too hot and fucking started going on fire. And everybody's dead.
The nice case here under the table.
I'm taking the card. He can keep
hey, look, it's fuck you, guy.
Thank you so much for coming out, ladies and gentlemen. Lisa Su, CEO of AMD.
I hope she drops on the way out.
She
only just left one thing that would have been so excellent.
Every year, I really I hope for someone to vomit on stage or something during the interview, and it never fucking happens. No one trips over and breaks their leg on stage.
The one guy that would do it would be fucking Gabe. So
Half-Life 3 confirmed.
Fucking stroke.
He has a stroke, runs away, kinda, and he slips on his own vomit. It falls right on his own ass. Ass explosion, fucking shit everywhere.
Yeah, it's a cameraman tries to desperately pan away and accidentally zooms right in.
Yeah. Hey, cameraman starts barfing. Everybody starts barfing. It's just a river of barf just flies out of the fucking auditorium.
We've been working on an expansion for Armor 3 for a couple of months, and it's finally.
And then every chipset gets destroyed.
Major component of it. So let's roll the video.
Take a look.
What are we playing? Oh, world exclusive. Is this Half-Life 3? Bohemian.
Better be.
This better be Half-Life 3, or
I'm gonna. Armor Free DLC.
I'm gonna burn this convention down with the AMD cards. Oh. Is this graphics? What is this? Euro Truck Simulator 3. Or 4. Whatever one's next. What the fuck is this? Looks really good.
Just Coaster.
No. That would be a world exclusive. Oh, I know what it is. The Lost video game. Finally here.
Finally.
The sequel. What is this? Is gonna be a fucking airplane simulator? Yeah, I guess. Oh shit! This guy got really big out of nowhere.
Oh, it's Arma.
Is it Arma?
It might be Arma.
All right, let's roll.
I was joking about it being Arma.
Yep,
Arma
it is. What the fuck?
Wow.
A new terrain.
Arma 3.
Wow, Arma 3 looks really good graphically.
Yeah. Coming 2016.
I couldn't give a fuck less, but cool.
Piece. I mean, tell me a little bit about what is Tanawa.
Yeah, well, welcome to Tanawa. It's what we call our new theater of
war. There's 20 minutes of bullshit.
It's the first time we've explored a Pacific Island setting, and what we've just seen is something like 100 square kilometers of jungly island archipelago.
This is time that could have been spent jerking it to anime. Jesus.
I'm going to go jerk it to some anime. Where's my Paul Blart / Yu-Gi-Oh! Fanfic?
The Arma games have always felt like the terrain is
that exists, by the way.
Characters of the game. And, I mean,
Christ.
I read some of
not
it.
Really found in
it's pretty good.
Game.
Yeah, exactly. I think the setting is something really fresh for the Arma series. And our environment lead, Martin, he's described this from the very beginning as a green.
We're going Broadway, boys.
So
fucking 2 hours long.
More gritty than your typical holiday resort. And I'm really looking forward to
God, no
making some
cares.
Cool military scenarios in there.
And I mean, I also saw that
no
island seems to be
one cares.
Is this going to change
the can I recommend something to get on Steam while that big sale is going? No, because I'm not with the end of deals.
For the Arma series.
Yeah, tell us
I
what the deals
like
are.
All of the terrains which have been such a massive part
no,
of
good. Is there any deal?
I don't know, they have daily deals. They've had some decent ones, I just haven't bought anything because
it's a richly detailed kind of authentic world.
but definitely the islands, the archipelago.
Batman's coming out. Yeah, and you buy that. I don't got any time for other games. Maybe still need to finish Witcher 3.
Underwater as well.
And I got Elder Scrolls Online.
Are you buying the crew?
And we talked about this right before you came on the stage that you guys are such huge believers in.
Actually, I should say I had the crew. Forgot I sold it.
Exactly, it's a whole new canvas for modders to do to make all their creations on. Can be anything from authentic military experiences to completely crazy stuff. I'm looking forward to dinosaurs myself, for example.
Well, I mean, I'm also a little bit curious about. We've talked about the terrain extensively, but what are some of the other new features and gameplay that will be coming along with Tanawa?
Well, we definitely know that we make a game as a platform. So we have our own vision of what Arma 3 is, and we also have to think about the modders. So the features that we're bringing along, like we see some of the screen space reflections, we see the water technology, so it's going to look a little bit more beautiful.
This ruined E3.
Jesus. I won't say that.
Really nail that down for
now, if they announce Half-Life 3,
a few other things aside, like the expansion
I might wake up
really
a little bit.
Content pack built around Tanawa, but also with weapons and
a little?
And maybe.
Lots of factions competing.
Well, I'm super excited to see the game. And of course,
I'm not super excited. Make me super excited. Show me games.
Again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much.
Real games, not fucking MOBA bullshit and fucking Arma bullshit and bullshit. Don't show me bullshit. Show me good shit.
Now, our next guest is working on an
Arma look cool, though.
Beautiful
fuck you.
Indie game called Beyond
I'm just kidding.
Eyes. Let's welcome to the stage.
Oh, this fucking game.
Sherita Halato.
Okay.
Hey!
Hi!
Welcome! Hey!
Thrilled to finally get the chance to meet you. Please, yes. Come join me.
All right.
Go ahead, sell my lap.
I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about
come on, let's play.
Gameplay.
Who's she?
She's the girl that made that game.
It's an exploration game.
Good talk.
Literally means she's a video game cat lady.
Yeah, good talk. She has 14 cats. One dog, just for variety.
Walking around. So because she's blind,
but she does not look at you. Doesn't even look at the dog. The world, so she doesn't like
she
the dog.
Smell things or
creative director Tyrone Squid. I'm sorry. Who?
Tyrone Squid?
Visualize them as she perceives them at that moment.
Is he a kid or a squid?
Kind of memes.
This looks like more Kickstarter bullshit.
This actually no, this isn't Kickstarter. They announced this at
she made a game about a blind girl
at the Microsoft press conference.
And then when she comes closer and smell kind of
that made me sad.
She realizes
what
this is not a fountain. It's
the fact that she couldn't see. She's blind.
And you kind of play with that.
I mean, the big thing that I
well, we could see, so this is fucking immediately strikes dumb. So she won't ever bump into anything.
But of course, audio is
I'm assuming that the controls are massively affected.
Yes.
Maybe you don't even control her. Maybe you have to, like... Well, you said something about audio, so maybe you have to, like, bang a spoon on a gate. Hey, over here, come here.
Hey.
Yeah, yeah, over here, you stupid asshole. Here. Come on. Hey, you dummy.
We started thinking about sounds that...
Stop being so loud.
That's so fucked.
All games are art.
All games are art. They have to be art or they're shit. You'll never see Call of Duty hanging up at the Smithsonian.
You'll never see a blind Call of Duty character.
Unless he got hit by a flashbang.
Actually, is what was that process like? Testing these to make sure that the player wouldn't be confused while exploring these environments.
So originally when
I thought one guy chilling there on his fucking laptop. One guy just chilling back there with his laptop.
There were two people just sticking around on their phones.
Yeah, there's like two or three. I saw that.
The one journalist that decided to show up. I guess I'll come on. I could be doing literally anything else.
Some things that how things are perceived by different people based on their experiences. So that was kind of the start.
I wish someone just yelled out, when's the show over?
Just a lot of thinking and talking to people and trying, basically, iterating on the thing.
And what has really been a big challenge for you as an indie developer working on a first-time title? Like
this game looks cute.
She's got to face her fears.
Basically, yes.
Yeah, she's got to face her fears like gates and grass.
I think I was lucky that I never made
My biggest fear is a wooden gate, I'll be honest with you.
I can't stand this gate. Fuck that. Yeah. Walk away.
And if I had known from the start that it was going to be
this long of a process, please God, I probably please would have contained myself a little still better, there. But
because I didn't know,
so it's coming out summer this year. So when? Like August, maybe? July?
A lot bigger.
Probably August.
And more ambitious. So getting the scope there was certainly a good lesson for a future project.
Well, I've said this before, that's cool. I'll probably get that. That's real cool, girl. All right, next.
Thank you so much, Sharita.
I love games about walking.
Well, you might not even make her walk. You have to probably, like, make sounds.
We don't even know how to fuck the game controls. We just talk about it.
Streamers have been blasting each other to death in it.
Yeah.
It's a game called Dirty Bomb. We're going to bring to the stage the CEO of Splash Damage. It's Paul Wedgwood.
Splash Damage. Oh, good. It's the Brink Boys.
Brink Boys.
You know, for the past 10 years, we've been so fortunate to work on some of the world's biggest intellectual properties.
Yeah, how about you, step in the middle?
Quake,
I'll stand on the side there.
Batman Arkham Origins.
You want to go ahead and step in the middle of the goddamn stage?
Nah.
But today is actually it's fine. A real first for us.
Give nice bleeples over here, come on.
We're not going to kill you.
That we own, that's actually our game. And that control
Look at the splash damage player. Like, I'm not saying this thing is fucking boring.
Oh, fucking, who cares? It may brink.
More than 2 years ago, we involved the whole community in the game in our private forums. And we've had tens and thousands of messages posted.
Wanting refunds for Brink.
Giving us feedback on competition.
You can go get the game now for $1.
And so on. So we're really pleased.
So you could buy 60 of them for the same price you bought one of them
PC
a couple years ago.
Website for a giveaway of a mercenary called Fragger. You can get your Steam code there today and view the full version of the game as well.
Oh yeah.
Thank you very much.
Of what? What's the game?
The game. Some men. You get Steam code. For a higher cause.
God. Honor, justice, it's very a comedic trailer. Freedom. Some call
these men heroes. We and you know I love war games.
Yeah, it is. Scrubs. Scrubs. Ready to fuck. What a fucking loser.
We're not soldiers. We're hired.
What
guns.
Is this?
There's only one thing we fight for.
You know, just talking about.
I know, but what's the title? Cash. I know. Destroy the primary
objective. Some weird title. I said it like 2 minutes ago, I don't even remember what the fuck I said. Reminds me of TF2.
Yeah, every game reminds you of TF2 now.
Well, no, there's a big guy with a machine gun, there's a black dude.
No, I wasn't saying you're wrong. I'm saying it's because every game is ripping off Team Fortress 2. Like, look at that fucking game we saw earlier. That fucking, what is it called? Gigantic? Shigantic? Whatever it's called. That's just pretty much TF2. Or Smite, or whatever the fuck it's trying to be. Oh no! My black friend.
No.
Oh.
Oh, goodness.
Trick or treat, motherfucker.
Oh, of course it. Of course the sniper's all showing as well.
Sniper always gets fucked up. Oh, yeah. Real Indiana Jones shit you did right there. Yep.
Crystal skull, like.
Wow.
Oh, good shit. So fucking...
That's pretty good. But it's made by Kira. But she's about to get blasted, so... Oh, no, she's fine. Oh, yeah. She just burned her skin off. You all right. Clean up,
you Jesus. To play dirty.
But how about the black guy? He died.
Oh, dirty bomb, free. Right? Yeah, it's like, it's free to play.
Black guy on Steam
now.
First.
Okay.
Dirty bomb, yeah. Dirty bomb.
Dirty bomb.
Dirty bomb.
Dirty bomb.
For free.
A trailer that always makes me laugh. And now let's take a look at a completely.
This is the first time we've seen that trailer. Fucking liar.
A game recently announced from the maker of Gone Home.
Oh, this game.
It's called Tacoma. Let's bring to the stage Steve Gaynor.
From the guy that made Gay Home.
Hey, Steve.
Gone Home or Grow Home?
No, Gone Home.
Okay.
Now I know that
Gay
Tacoma
Home
was revealed yesterday. The
have we played Gone Home?
Been out for a little bit. We're going to take a look at it now, and this is really the first chance that we get to talk about the game. I mean, walk me through what the experience of Tacoma is.
Well, it's a first-person exploration game. You know, like Gone Home, it's about exploring a place and finding out the story of what happened there. But in this case, unlike that game, we're in a near future kind of high-tech space station setting. where not only are you seeing these kind of digital recordings of things that happen on the station, but you can use the zero gravity environment to your advantage to propel yourself through the environment and see if you can connect.
What are the sort of gameplay opportunities that open up when you get that sort of zero-G space?
Well, I think something that is, yes, in a way limiting about your traditional kind of walking simulator.
I'm failing.
Is it all
effectively?
It takes place
I can't take this anymore. Like you're in this
Well, no, it's almost over.
10 more minutes.
Yeah, really? Give it 10 more minutes.
Last
of you missed like something here, really good, like Euro Truck Simulator 42. Or 2015 and 16 edition.
I don't think that's much of a risk.
But what after they announce, like, everybody that watches it right now, for the next 20 minutes or so, gets it free.
I might miss, like,
gets every game that we've featured today free.
That would be good, even though I wouldn't play any of them, besides maybe Hitman and Deus Ex.
And that Blind Girl game.
Yeah, but... I play Hitman before that.
You know, it all comes down to
a game about murder or a game about a blind child.
To use the environment to
I'm going to murder.
Give the player the freedom to explore it on their own. To not say you have to go here, then there, and really like guide the player by the nose and say here's how you have to play the game, but still let the environment point them to say well, there might be something here if you're finished here. This might still be interesting.
I'm not really even tired. It's just I'm so bored that I'm tired. That makes sense.
Help them find all the cool stuff in the game without forcing their hand, you know?
Yeah, I mean, Gone Home was a relatively small environment in a house. I mean, how large is the space station?
Oh, the picture of Phil Spence on the PC Gaming Show website looks like he got stung by a bee.
Sized facility, right? It's a small space station between the Earth and the Moon.
He probably did. He probably went outside for the first time in 3 years. And he was like, fresh air for once. And then a bee flew up and hit him right in the face. He's like, I'm just going to stay in the Microsoft head office forever.
He would also like a fucking stroke victim.
Yeah, the stroke after he got stung. Ow! I can't deal with pain!
Say what kind of furniture would there have been in this space station. So that's one of the things that we're really excited about is Gone Home was really about.
It's like he did like a impression of like a stroke victim, and he did that whole thing that people do with like the fucking sideways face shit, and like it just got stuck there.
Wait, what?
The picture.
Phil, if you keep making that face, it's going to get stuck like that. Just don't tell me what to do, Mum.
Don't tell me what to do, Mum. So anyway, I want to introduce to you the new X-Lite.
Awesome, thank you so much for having me.
Sorry, I had a stroke when I was 8.
Cool. Cheers,
man. My mommy told me to stop doing strokes.
You just had a fucking stroke on the fucking E3 Xbox conference, and nobody realized because they're looking at the damn games.
They're looking at those Dance Central games.
It was emasculating.
Oh, yeah, that's what I said. Scary.
And of course, the folks over at Dance Central.
Amnesia.
They're looking at Just Dance 4228. Oh, Soma, okay. I'm interested in this. It's from the guys who made Amnesia.
Hi, guys. Thank you, Sean. So yeah, since we released Amnesia nearly 5 years ago now,
it's been 5 years.
This is really like proved my hypothesis that like British people in E3 conferences make them dramatically worse. Like the majority of people featured on this have had like British accents and have said nothing of merit and shown nothing of interest.
Hold on, this guy's going to show off Soma. It's going to be the new game from the director of... What is it called? I mean, from the makers of Amnesia.
Amnesia.
The Dark Descent. They should say The Dark Descent because people will think they're thinking of Machine for Figs.
I'm about to get spooked, aren't I?
Oh yeah, Soma looks fucking freaky. It's about robots and AI and shit. And they go crazy. Except it's not Terminator where it's fun.
Just scary.
Yeah, it's a horror game. It's Amnesia.
Catherine,
what do you think?
Catherine, are you in there? I hope you're not in there because I think someone died.
Don't look at it. Look at what? Oh fuck, don't look at it, man. What are you doing? Don't look at it. It's like the Slender Man. Don't look at it. You're looking at it.
You're looking at it.
Run! Stop looking at it! That was it.
Run.
Jesus. Wow, September 22nd? Alright. I'm pumped for that. Except we only showed 12
already
seconds.
Already stressed out.
Oh, fucking.
Coming up next,
I hope the game starts out the same way. Don't look at this. What, you want me to look at that?
Mod from Arma.
Just
it's
run.
A game called Daisy that is under continued development.
Daisy again?
Let's bring out the project lead. It's Brian Hicks.
What?
Well, it's not done.
Well, they brought out the guy that made DayZ before to talk about his other shitty game.
You look fantastic.
He's got to do two speeches.
You do. You do.
That was such a vain question. Although I will say I'm very proud
of you. I hope his chair rolls off that fucking that thing and he falls and he breaks.
I love eventual applause.
He's still got at least 7 or 8 cue cards there.
Yeah. Well, that last one was really quick with Soma. Which, of course, it was an interesting game, so they had to do it quick.
No, that's a good point.
Because it was on PS4.
Don't look at it.
You know, I don't think...
don't look at what?
Team or
yeah, don't,
team
just don't look at
it.
Knew what to expect
it.
When we,
yeah, don't
we
just don't look at the cards either, because then you'll realize how long it'll be until we're done.
2.5 years.
Don't look at it. The fucking PC gaming show. Don't look at it.
Don't look at it.
The key things is just.
Oh my god! Look at its stuttering animation. He'll get there eventually. Yeah, it'd be cool if they made DayZ and then like made it like functional and fun. Oh, that's funny. Right when I said functional, he said functional as well.
Right, heart-beating game.
I should work with
and
them.
In terms of the early access model, I mean, do you find continued
success?
Oh, he says
make DayZ actually fucking work.
We're gonna make it so that the zombies don't glitch out into walls and then murder you instantly because the combat's so bad and the camera work is awful.
Definitely nothing Dean had expected.
They should just get rid of all the zombies.
Well, in terms of some of those features that you talked about,
which
they should just get rid of DayZ.
Yeah, they should get rid of DayZ. DayZ, DayZ.
We're looking at rolling out a pack of 3 new vehicles paired with DayZ the functionality of those required parts.
They should just get rid of it because it's fucking stupid.
DayZ Zimbabwe.
Bring back that whole feeling of DayZ. I found a vehicle. It could be one of any different type of vehicles. And
look at all those trees. That looks realistic.
Or have a friend watch the vehicle and go out and find the
resources
required to get it out. It's not. Not one of those, I found a vehicle, it's used.
I'm so upset that I bought DayZ.
Well, this guy's like,
because I know so many people.
He's mistaking the community because he says, have a friend watch out for your vehicle. There's no friends in that fucking game.
Unless you, like, bring a friend into your game and then spend 3 hours trying to find them.
Exactly.
Alright, I found you! Instantly murdered.
And then you're both shot.
He gets murdered. Isn't every map exactly the same, too? I was
interested talking they're all the tonight, same
right?
Fucking
map, right?
Yeah.
So there's no, there's like almost nothing random except maybe some of the item drops.
Still play the game.
Well, all the item drops are random.
All of them. Yeah, but the world itself isn't randomly generated.
I think people have custom apps for it. I've seen custom apps for it before.
Oh, cool. The developers can't even do that.
Yeah, this is me right here. That's me.
Yeah.
That's
every time I play.
Well, DayZ's also a mod. They can't mod a mod.
You know, Minecraft was made by, like, what, one person? Modders,
which is a big thing. Sure.
And Minecraft had random generation since the beginning.
Yeah, that's true.
Single-player modding, we have,
so, it's also owned by Microsoft.
To fully embrace Steam Workshop. If you played Arma 2 DayZ,
DayZ's not. DayZ's owned by nobody because no one wants them.
I think
the idea is you go into the Steam Workshop, find what you want to install, you click it, and you're done. Like, you're in the game. And past that, I guess the big thing that everybody wanted to know when it came to modding is we are going to be
click it and you're done.
Tool, a separate piece of software that will allow people to host their own DayZ servers on whatever hardware they want, LAN party, their own data center.
They'll be able to host their own DayZ server, you know, on their own computer, at their own data center. Oh yeah, I just have a few data centers kicking around.
Yeah, I like how they said servers. You know, they only have like a half of a server left. They can only afford like half. They're like borrowing a server from EA or so.
Part
some
of
other
the
company.
Thing that has taken a lot of time for us to
that's not
DayZ,
true. They probably have plenty of money.
In
fuck them.
Of course. And as we get to towards our feature complete area, that's when we start to roll out the tool set for Infusion.
Wish
and
I had that money.
A bit of a learning curve,
for
but
making
the idea
a mediocre
is,
game.
Is we have new scripts, new animation graph. Everything is designed to give people more control and easier control over DayZ.
I'm excited to see DayZ finally enter the beta. Because, as we talked about, then with a long-standing...
Wait, hold on, it's not in beta yet?
...in the Steam Early Access. Thank you so much for coming
it's
up.
It's been out for 3.5 years.
coming out 2025.
The beta will?
It's coming out in the same year that new Hitman game's coming up.
Yeah, but like look at Minecraft. Minecraft was out 2 years and then it was fully released.
Yeah.
This has been 3.5. It's like going into beta finally. What is this? Aircraft something they said? Oh, what is this?
Something on Mars.
Oh, Total Recall the game.
Sweet.
Bohemia again? Shit.
Yeah, Bohemia's had a lot of shit in this conference.
Oh, another space game! I haven't had one of those since the last 5 minutes. A space
actual gameplay footage.
A space sim exploration game. Okay.
God, you gotta hand it to like Microsoft and Sony. When they have a bad conference, at least the trailers don't look as janky as this.
Right. I like that. I don't know if you noticed that, but that person sleeping in that bed had like maybe 3 inches from the bed to the roof to sleep.
Don't worry about it.
It's real cozy. They actually had to put the bed, like he had actually like glue himself to the ceiling and then put the bed under him.
How do you get out of bed?
You don't.
You slide.
You have to destroy the fucking ceiling to get out. Take on Mars. Now on Steam Early Access. Oh my. Wait, hold on. Beta coming this summer. All began as an armor. So Daisy has to wait 3.5 years before it enters beta. That game gets announced right now. It's already coming into beta in like a month.
He is a long-standing figure in the gaming community. All right. He just recently started a company called Boss Key Productions, working on a title called Project Blue Streak.
It's Gabe.
Join me in welcoming Cliff Bleszinski.
Ah, Cliffy B. Why would it be Gabe? He has fucking Valve. He wouldn't make another fucking company.
Good to see you. Thanks so much for coming out.
I like your butt divot.
Oh, I know this is.
Yeah,
this
I got a lot of money from this Valve company. I was thinking,
I like Cliffy B.
It's still warm, actually. It's quite nice.
Let's see what you got, Cliffy. Except
John Gibson, who started the day off, but.
Doesn't he hate people? Just people.
He just hates people. That's fine. Yeah. I hate people too. What it was like looking at all the trends. You guys make me sick.
I had fun. He says he had the tiniest bottle of water I've ever seen.
Right, I mean, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, I think it's cut off by the table.
It was a lot of fun, but honestly, I got really bored.
No, if you actually like saw the hard cam, it was very tiny.
Okay. Trailers. Oh yeah, they make mini ones.
I miss this stuff. I miss being a part of it.
Or maybe he's
honestly after 6 months.
Maybe he's trying to like say something.
Gee, I'm parched. No, one gulp.
It's like a thimble.
Thimble of water. So much stuff going on.
Yeah, it's pretty small.
VR. We have early access. We have the sort of indie renaissance.
Yep. I bet he thinks that's really cool. Fucking hipster. I drank small bottles of water before it was cool.
I mean, I'd worked on Gears for so long, and Gears is
also fucked your mom before it became a fad. Looks great.
Good job, Rob. I want to drink some water, but I don't want to be hydrated.
I want to drink water, but I don't want to look like an asshole when I drink all of it.
Right now, you know, there's so much more room for unique weaponry in a first-person shooter that's not just
drink too much
shotgun
water in front of
or an AR-15 or a rocket launcher. There's a lot of unique twists you can do in the sci-fi space that kind of really make things really interesting and unique.
And in terms of the gameplay, I mean, with Project Blue Streak having...
What is this? Project Brown Streak? Jesus.
This is their new game. How does look, all those colors. Pink, green, that's definitely not... Thing, right? That definitely hasn't been in Gears of War before.
I turned 40 this year, right?
You turned 40?
Japan! My favorite!
My favorite!
So,
Japan.
What I'm reminding is, the older studio members...
It's Stranglehold, too.
...making characters and weapons...
Fuck off.
...that are easier to aim, they can't aim. So it's more like area of effect.
That's some bullshit.
Weapons, right? Yeah. Whereas the younger folks in the studio who are, 20s and whatnot, interns and they just cream everybody with the high precision weapons.
Boss Key Productions. So, I mean... What is it called? So is it just called Boss Key?
Right now, like Overwatch, like Gigantic, that we've got the chance to see earlier today.
Sure.
See so many... games coming out with
Well, some companies name themselves after their game.
When I had the idea a year and a half ago to make a small
size
studio with,
I can't think of any, but
game, I was not the only
you gotta believe me.
So we're actually happy that there's games like Overwatch and Gigantic out there.
No, I'm typing in Stranglehold too.
Specifically say, let's not.
That's
go
never
that
gonna
direction.
Happen. You know, there's no one wants it. Of, you know, John,
nobody even bought the license, or Midway went fucking bankrupt, so it's dead.
We're going for something that's
exactly
a little bit more realistic.
John would even want it.
Gigantic's over here, and you know, you have that League of Legends like kind of very colorful look, and you have your depressing kind of dark kill zone-y gears environment over here. We think there's like a halfway point.
Okay, that's that guy.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Yeah, I mean, I was talking about CSGO.
Someone fucked up. I mean, don't get me wrong. That's more interesting to look at than everything else, but...
The one that just, for some reason...
Guy charged with the OBS just got fucking bored. Oh, shit.
They're using OBS. That'd be some shit. It's free.
Insane. Yeah, I mean, like, they clearly didn't spend any money on this set, so they're not going to spend, like, the $30 next bit, come on.
Yeah, there's some fucking room that was, like, empty, and they're like, hey, we should have a PC game thing.
The kind of thing that's easy to learn, lifetime to master.
Drag over the hotel desk and fucking slap the PC gamer logo on it.
Insane. So, you know, a person playing this game at the peak of their skill level who's truly mastered it after potentially thousands of hours is going
to
look like a...
So go on the left to exist in that piece.
Right here. They're comparing himself to LeBron James.
Yes.
Highly skilled
I'm like LeBron James, black guy beat my dog. Or is that the other one? I don't know. Who's the one who beats his dog?
Terrell Owens?
Something Terrell Owens?
Terrell?
And like, in order to make a game an e-sport, you have
well,
to
you know who that is.
Skill-based... that has an amazing community,
be quiet.
Respect that community, and work with the community to build up to actually hopefully have people play the game professionally.
Michael Vick.
And, you know,
Michael Vick.
There
yeah.
you go. That's right. He plays basketball.
And I mean, a lot of people know you from work with console games, but why PC? Why the PC platform for the PC community?
The beauty of the PC, and this isn't to slag anything about consoles.
Why PC? Why?
Why?
Why did you choose this?
Why you fuck? Tell me before I stab you.
We can get a version out there, potentially, you know, early
access. I'm a fucking kill you.
Iteration, have tests.
So, well, why PC? All right, it's cheap to develop on.
Some white box apps. Continue to grow the community on a rapid basis. That's one of the many things the PC gets us. Also, keyboard and mouse, man. You know, I love my console shooters, but keyboard and mouse for first-person shooters still
the
best
Twitch,
way to go.
Yeah.
It's the only way to go.
Keyboard and mouse, only way to go.
Let me say thank you him so much for makes him look really short. PC. If only everyone did that, and I am talking to you.
He's a little baby. Look at him.
Thank you so much.
Cliffy B is like 80 years old,
man. Ladies and gentlemen, Cliff Blazinski from Blue, Project Blue
Half
Street.
Half of that? Yeah, he's actually 40.
You got the chance to do an earlier demo with Strafe.
I know, I heard that.
But this
but
upcoming
demo,
I am going to be a participant.
80 in his heart.
And it's going to be a game called Enter the Gungeon. Let's warmly
welcome
Enter
the Gungeon,
David
Brooks
and Joe
Hardy. It's a game with guns and...
Hello!
Hi, how you doing?
Welcome. Now, let's go ahead
Joe
and hop right into the game where I'm going to be playing co-op.
Yeah. I hope it looks like some retro indie bullshit.
Well, guess what, Christian? Guess what, Christian? I think you're in luck.
Oh, good.
Oh, good.
I think you're about to get what you just fucking wanted.
See, it's an original pixel art.
I'm sure it'll still be...
Oh, good.
Oh, good.
Now, we're stepping into these rooms, and my understanding is...
Oh, good.
...between Binding of Isaac...
This game looks fun.
Sort of shooters.
Shoot them, so, fucking.
Just the basics.
Fucker, yeah.
So
an indie 2D sprite based twin stick shooter. Another one.
I've seen that before.
But this one's different. Really good
dungeon design. This is like Newgrounds. I love it.
Look, it's like Geometry Wars. Everything's colorful when they blow up.
Bullet hell game, we thought to ourselves, what better way to...
I like colors.
It is Bullet Hell. It's literally Castle Crashers with Bullet Hell elements.
So actually, this game does look good. So shut your fucking...
No, it doesn't, Gore.
Yes, it does, you fucking idiot.
No, it only looks good because you've been watching shit for 2 hours.
I mean, earlier when we first got the...
It looks good if you have someone...
Well, that means you said something positive about it. You said this looks good compared to all the other shit.
You're going to need to practice it a lot. I mean, what is it about that
semi-positive,
really difficult experience that you find so compelling? Well... Just to be honest, victory is always more rewarding when you earn it. Right. So, it's not difficulty for the sake of difficulty. We make it difficult.
Oh my god! Someone needs to throw a fucking pie. I'm getting fucking bored.
To avoid damage themselves, so they really feel like they earned it.
And we have the dodge roll with iframes. But we
fucking
also
PC
have,
gaming Shay, sponsored by Ambien.
Sponsored by Ambien. Lasts for up to 3 hours.
So you just need to
That's
use
how long the convert has
I mean, this looks like it has so many influences from so many games. I mean, even this boss reminds me very much of Link to the Past. Yes, this is our version.
Looks like a Link to my ass.
Just with a lot more bullets. I want you to know I am trying as hard as I can. So far, I don't think I've been hit more than once. But
I'm glad they made a
mode enabled for me because
their version of a Link to the Past fight
yes,
because they couldn't
this.
Take anything original.
Yeah.
Well, that's an homage.
Like, this is perfectly original. This is a perfectly original twin stick. Indeed. Yeah.
This is an homage, fuckboys, alright?
Alright, that did not go very successfully for me.
It's an homage.
Joe has an extremely OP
it's
weapon
an homage.
To demolish the rest of the
A homage. Statues.
So what is the variety of weapons?
So shut your
like
fucking hole.
There's actually over 200 hand-designed weapons in the game.
Oh my god.
And,
oh my god.
Of multiple weapons,
said, oh my god.
Oh my god.
It's like he didn't expect it or something.
So I basically go down, battle.
This is supposed to be like selling PC
is.
Gaming.
Whoever was in charge of this design.
Most people in the crowd are
it, but,
looking down on the ground because there's probably something more interesting down there.
Just like my shoes.
So the game
it's like a cockroach.
Flip tables,
hey buddy. Hey buddy, what's up with you?
Probably die, but hopefully along the way you've unlocked some new stuff that you can use in the next runs. For any of you who are big fans of the Twitch,
it's your new pet cockroach.
Strongly recommend enter the
Come on, buddy. Let's go and kill ourselves together.
Thank you. That guy looked like he'd been crying.
No, he was yawning so much he started like to tear up. That's what I do sometimes too.
A game called StarCraft.
StarCraft. Now I'm officially going to die from boredom.
Especially StarCraft Brood War. 17 years ago.
Oh my god.
Please join me in welcoming to the stage Chris Siggity and Dustin Browder from
Chris
Blizzard
Siggity?
Entertainment. Dustin, what is up?
Siggity.
Chris, welcome. Please join me.
Siggity. Siggity.
Yo, it's Shigati.
Siggity.
Bugatti. Of authority.
Oh my
Heroes
god.
Storm has just come out. You're the new MOBA kid on the block. What's finally have it.
No, God.
I have a MOBA game. Super
exciting.
Yes.
No, Heroes of the Storm's already a thing. So they're just coming out and announcing Heroes of the Storm.
Or Blizzard the game. We
if you didn't know already.
In concert with the community in a very big way.
And oh
it's
my God.
Finally arrived. So very exciting for the team in general, and this is just the beginning.
They better end this with something.
Yeah, I mean, what's especially interesting to me is that many players of the MOBA genre will be familiar with the business model of releasing new heroes one at a time. And of course, Heroes of the Storm does this, but today we're talking about the first...
God, video games are just the fucking worst, aren't they?
Yeah, they're terrible.
I might need to get up and, like, do something. Like, do a jumping jack, because I fucking... Or push up if I could. Attempt a push-up, because I'm fucking falling asleep.
Is this just Heroes of the Storm trailer? Is that what this is?
Well, to be fair, Blizzard has some pretty cool trailers.
Yeah.
I've never seen a Blizzard of the Storm trailer yet. Or whatever it's called.
Burning hells. God, I might as well just not go to sleep now.
That conflict continues.
Huh? Might as well just not go to sleep now.
Hashtag no sleep.
Yeah, punch him. Oh yeah, shit, Hadouken. Yeah, fuck him up. Oh my god. No chance.
I love Doder.
I love Doder.
Doder.
Doder 2. It would be great if Heroes of the Storm was just a DLC for Doder 2. We tricked
it's
you,
like,
it's not a real game.
It's like League is based off of a game type and down. And yeah.
In what Diablo?
Warcraft 3.
It was really?
Yeah.
Ah. Didn't know that.
The entirety of MOBA shit in general became like, it was all from like a mod for Warcraft 3.
I don't know what League of Legends be.
Bad.
I know it's a MOBA or whatever, right?
It's bad. Yeah, it's MOBA.
I don't know how it is.
It is bad.
I don't know. Is it a free to play game?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because no one would ever
free
pay
to
this.
Pay. Pay to win.
Pay to free. Heroes of the Storm. Eternal Conflict.
Well, in all fairness, Dota's very good with its like free to play.
Am I seeing some empty seats?
Yeah,
you know,
but I first
want to
ask.
Yep.
Think about what it means.
Those are the people that are. Those are the people that disintegrated.
Yeah, they died from boredom. They had to like get the body bags out. Wizard World
entering the next. Oh, Neo, they're Ash.
Yeah.
It's heroes, it's battlegrounds, and more.
Yeah.
And it's coming.
Swept
them
up into a can.
Next week. Oh, so we're super no point in identifying this shit.
I also understand
no, he did.
That the treasure goblin from Diablo 3 is a feature in the game.
Right.
Oh my god, the treasure goblin from Diablo 3 is in the game?
You get the opportunity to kill the treasure goblin before he escapes through his portal, and if so, you get some bonus gold.
What the best part about that trailer? It was for an expansion.
Yeah.
Genius, yeah. Man.
But they released an expansion 2 weeks ago.
Now, in terms of
it sounded like he was talking about, like, when someone doesn't know anything about video games, but they try and make something up that sounds like a video game. Like, you got to get chase the treasure goblin to get the bonus gold.
Chase the treasure goblin so you can win the game against the Lord of Evil. And then you can fight. Then you have to fight your doppelganger, who is completely black, and you have to fight him. And then Ganon shows up, and he's like Ooga Booga, and then you have to fight him. And then you fight Mother Brain and Lord of the Rings.
Can he deal damage? He
can't
deal
then damage. The Eye of Moose shows up and shoots you in the head with a gun bullet.
Lowers his death timer. Which
and then
to
I
get
fall
back
asleep.
Into action even sooner. So you can imagine
no with a gun bullet as opposed
sort of
to a regular bullet.
Gun bullet. And then when your death timer ends, you return to the battle exactly where that wraith is standing. You don't need to come back from the
Dustin.
Right there, maybe just delivering just vengeance
Mirror
on the guy
cookie.
Who killed you.
Can anyone deal damage back to you?
No, you're just a wraith just floating around.
That sounds
but
super fucking cheap.
For sure.
What's this cookie?
Die
no, fucking ways of squaring. If you become a wraith, you fucking get to run around when you're waiting for your death timer, and then you can fucking spawn in where the fuck you're standing. So you just kill the guy that fucked you up.
I guess the players are taking too long to figure out all the cheap shit you can do.
Yeah,
so
they're just
announcing it.
Maybe some other team members might leap in to help you out as well. So he's this very powerful warrior character. That can really
they really
the
want this to go to EVO or wherever.
His second heroic ability
or CraftCon or wherever fucking StarCraft
that
does.
That allows him to move across the battlefield. Yeah. It's the March of the Black King, and it allows him to
march
sort
of the Black King.
Giant mace. And it reminds
yeah.
me
that
of the
sounds
boss battle
fake.
From Diablo 3, where he's unstoppable. There's nothing you can do to prevent this once he winds it up, and he deals ferocious amounts of damage, healing himself with every swing as well. So he can really plow through an enemy team. Really add a lot of value to a team fight.
And I mean, I know also the monk is being added. I don't know if you can talk at all about the monk, but I'm going to ask you to.
Oh, please tell us about the monk. I want to know. What is the monk? What does he do?
Is the monk a panda?
What does he do?
Help heal friends. And at the same time, we're trying to do something very special and different with his talents. So the monk is a character that can choose his own trait.
He could choose his own trait?
So instead of having a usual set of
so he could be a gunman?
Choose what trait he would like.
That doesn't seem very godly.
Attack-oriented character, more of a
this game's
kind of
stupid.
Brawler, or more of a traditional support
you
character.
Bald
really
fuck. Grow some hair.
This talent system and really push
look
it,
at the guy next to you. Take his fucking advice.
Take half his hair.
Took half of his hair. It would be 100% more than you have now. That's math.
With like so much content to draw.
That's actually true.
Your past IPs.
Someone quote me.
How do you do the sorting? Not just with. Which heroes you want to put
sucks.
In, but with these sort of ideas that
this
we're
going
to see today.
Well, there's a lot of different reasons. You know, obviously, Diablo support was something the community had been requesting for a long time that we wanted to do. The idea of having
we have two contrasting people here.
Was, you know,
bald as fuck, dude.
Different characters that could be
and a long as fuck fucking hair, dude.
You know, as maybe that kind of character. And really, we looked at it,
so
we felt like
the opposite. One keeps talking, the other one's not.
So, sometimes we have an idea for a game mechanic, something that
the
we
other one probably
the
has a wife.
Of what you've seen
the other
in
one
the
has
genre before. And sometimes it's just
husband.
A character that needs to be done. So, like, Arthas is going to happen. Like, we've got to do that guy. And sometimes it's just lots of different reasons.
Yeah, I mean,
one
for
I want
me,
dead.
So many of the heroes that really stand out
the
are
other
like
one
the Murkies, the Abathurs, the really fringe sort of characters. So I'm very excited
I
to
think,
see.
Yeah, heroes has tried.
Oh, no, don't talk.
Tried hard and I think succeeded.
Don't speak.
Fucking Hesher over here.
And there are these heroes
shut the fuck
you know,
up.
The designers are really killing it, I think, with
Game
the
Jesus.
Amount of variety you see between the heroes.
It's nicer to fucking lead singer Weezer to talk for him.
It's Weird Al Yankovic.
Executive Jesus for Blizzard Entertainment.
Executive Jesus.
That began like 17 years ago.
He looks
Starcraft 2 Legacy of the Void.
Yeah. Jeez,
oh my
Jesus.
God.
Super excited. Jesus. We're so Jesus. Excited about it. And honestly, very Jesus. Humbling to be a part of it because these stories around Jim Raynor, around
oh my God.
Artanis Kerrigan, these have been going on since the original Starcraft. You know, and then here with Starcraft 2, we're sort of finishing those in this epic conclusion.
Oh my God, this should have took
very,
like
very excited about it.
12 seconds to talk about. There's a new DLC. It's gonna have more stuff. Here's a couple things. Bam, bam, bam. Done. Okay, bye. Now enjoy all the other shit.
It's somewhat emotional, honestly.
Now enjoy going home. It's over.
Now enjoy the fun time you'll have at home playing the games that were not talked about at this conference.
Play some real games on your Xbox.
Go play some Dead Rising.
Very excited to share it.
What game that came out 2 years ago?
Video piece for any of you who know where the story ended at the end of Heart of the Swarm. Let's take a look at the Whispers of Oblivion.
No, that's not.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Let's take a look at the 14-minute demo. Oh, fuck. Shoot me in the face. At least the trailers for these games are okay.
I have some sad news.
What?
Since you guys were talking over it, this is actually the end of the storyline for StarCraft.
Oh,
This is the finale.
No. What? But how? When are they going to fight the Star Queen? Where's the Star Queen? Who's that? Is that the... What? Oh, that blew him up!
That's why he's seeing...
Oh no, oh he has energy stored. They have energy stored, they ripped off Halo. Great.
Goodness. They also have Arbiters.
Oh good, they ripped everything off from Halo. Halo is the most original RPG. Legacy of the Void trademark.
Halo Wars, the most original.
Wait, hold on.
RPG.
Three prologue missions. July 2015 beta. A beta for a prologue mission?
No, I think the beta's the prologue missions.
Oh.
And everything else
what
is full game.
Prologue missions? And when
I hope someone just goes Allah Akbar in this and just starts shitting everybody from the audience. That will make
they'll edit later where he moves his head a little bit.
Blizzard, the Covenant should stop making games and start making movies, Blizzard.
That connects those things. Oh my God. I'm gonna fucking shoot myself.
Actually, Blizzard can continue making games, they're just not allowed to talk about them anymore.
Now, Blizzard can make video games.
Address, no more.
They should make video games, but they shouldn't put them up. They should just play them. From the end of that and never talk about them. At the same time, we've got. If I even see a Twitter post saying, "Ooh, I'm liking this game," from a Twitter fucking employee, I'm going to his house. I'm going to take away his Twitter. And Zerg DNA
with forbidden and foul technology. Imagine this is how boring it must be to listen to the Crashcast when that was still a thing. And this
is the opportunity. Except no one listens to Crashcast. I've
got like 10 downloads an episode. Thank you.
Oh wow, I have no downloads because I don't have it on iTunes. Prophecy back together. So you still pay for those to be up on iTunes? We'll sort of
catch up no, it never was on iTunes.
Now,
all
of these missions will be free to all players.
Too fucking nice to talk.
Whether you bought or purchased StarCraft at all, so just sort of free
what
to the
a
world.
Sense.
But if you want early access, you need to pre-purchase Legacy of the Void. And we'll have a lot
I don't know why they're going so goddamn in detail about DLC.
I know so many people.
Oh, wait,
it might as well be StarCraft
now,
4 or whatever.
How do you balance
how many DLCs have there been?
The multiplayer component.
They're supposed to make 3 for StarCraft 2.
Right, so 2 came out already.
Of having 2 teams.
All right, so this is like the 5th game.
This is
the
trilogy.
The trilogy of DLCs that are pretty much games themselves.
And making sure players can get into and understand that experience. We got a whole other group
figured
of guys whose whole job is make sure that we've got this amazing campaign experience. We also got guys who are working in our arcade systems to make sure that we've got the best mod tools out there we can possibly provide our players. The real challenge, of course, is trying to keep everybody connected. But everybody's so focused on making their part of the game a great amazing experience.
What? I think this is great. I love that they keep talking for 20 minutes about a DLC that you fucking who cares?
At the final release, gentlemen, thank you so much for coming out.
Oh my God, he only has like one more card though.
That's a cover. He says, so like, make sure to say goodbye to everybody.
All right, so now the grand finale. A noose, like, drops down from the rafters. And
pulls out a gun.
He hangs himself, and before he, like, chokes to death, he shoots himself in the head. What?
We've gotten the chance to see one of the long-standing sci-fi series.
This is the final guest. I need to hear this.
And now we're getting a chance to look at one of the new ones. Let's take a look at a game that has ambition in spades. It's No Man's Sky.
No, that wasn't
worth it. No Man's Sky. Most anticipated game. Most anticipated game. 50 plus awards and nominations. No Man's Sky.
And now for the most important announcement of the night. Our final announcement. I have cancer. And I had about 6 months to live.
At best. Wait, did they say this is the final thing they're going to talk about?
Yeah.
Really?
He said so, but then they're also going to do, you know, the whole one more thing bullshit they always do.
I don't know. Whoa, one of them disappeared. Oh, no, it went through warp thing.
Never mind. Looks pretty sweet.
Yeah, No Man's Sky looked great.
Gentlemen, Sean Murray, the co-founder of Hello Games.
Oh, it's not this guy. Sean. Oh, my God. I hate this guy. His whole gimmick is that he's like really, really shy.
To finally get the chance to meet you, Sean. Now,
hey, you know, I mean, this game's gonna be good, I guess. You know, I mean, it's just a little game.
But. Yeah. Is there some news you have for me?
Yeah. So
it's canceled.
We were actually gonna announce a release date at E3.
It's
oh,
for a reason.
They're gonna announce a release date.
We'll announce a release date soon, and when we announce that release date, it will be for PS4 and PC at the same time.
Yay!
That's an announcement.
Now,
when they're going to announce it, it's going to be for the PC and PS4 release.
Is massive. What? How big's your team?
The million-dollar question, is he autistic or just British? You can never tell.
I mean, the trailer looks amazing.
Yeah, I think he's both.
That trailer was really fun.
Only autistic people can make a game
that
good.
I see all those put that together.
I know you had your own typeface in there.
Yeah, I thought
it's like
the Cannes Festival, like sort of laurels.
What's happened to them? LA's got to them.
But how do you go about...
Oops.
See? Look at him. Sorry, he's still bashful.
Has he been to AMD lounge?
How do you go about playtesting something?
He's been storing mounds of coke. Generation.
I'm gonna snort a whole thing of cocaine.
Of, like normal human playtesting.
Maybe just like really tired and bored.
Before, that we actually.
They just stand back fucking stage. You can't even see the trailers. You'd be a bit leapy, wouldn't you?
I wait for someone to come on stage and be like, "Man, I almost fucking fell the fuck asleep back there. What's going on?"
They just come up and be like, "Hey, guy, I'm trying to go to sleep. Could you shut up about your PC gaming?"
Come back from the cosmos, telling us
how to take a fucking nap back there.
God damn, man! I love this conference. I need a good fucking 14 hours of sleep. You provided.
I'm just expecting, like, they do the audience shot and you just see on the laptop, like, just a pair of tits or something.
That'd be amazing. That'd be the best conference ever. That happened. Either a big pair of tits or a huge dick.
Just a big black
dick. A big black, like, mandingo dick.
Yeah, somebody said that to me.
That would be fucking perfect.
Design of, like,
it's just like waves around. Like when that dick showed up during what was it, like the NFL or something?
Yeah, probably that's true.
For like half a second.
We grew up playing games like Elite.
Oh, that's I think I remember that.
I don't know if it was NFL. It was something.
It was some, yeah.
You know, and actually, there were a lot more games. There were a lot more open like that in those kind of like Commodore 64 days. And like early PC days, they were a lot more freer, open, and kind of, you know, almost wild. Like I remember, you would get.
I'm never watching this con.
You have no idea what anything did. And you would press all the buttons.
Don't worry, this conference is never happening again.
If it does, I'm never watching it again.
PC gamer officially on the shit list.
Games like this so
I'm never watching this again.
I mean, I think there has
this is the worst conference. At least EA was like abysmal, but only an hour. This is 2.5 hours so far.
Kind of open, more sandbox.
I'm never buying anything from AMD ever again just because they okayed this and put their name to it.
What was the moment that you thought that you could really pull this off?
They enabled this.
They're just looking at the fucking show notes of like what they're going to do. Oh, it's 2.5 hours, 3 hours? Oh, this is fine.
Yeah.
No.
I guess this might be entertaining for some people.
Grow more and more in confidence,
but they should be hanged.
In what we're doing, but this E3 is kind of when we've been showing boring. People going on.
The thing is, the AMD adverts were like the most entertaining bit of this.
Night at the Sony press conference.
At least because they were short.
Playing it live and showing yeah. people how it is. You know, it's a weird feeling to work on a game that so many people say, you know, I'm not sure if it's real and things like that. Because
of course.
You know that it is. You're playing it.
What's he fucking talking about?
So
I don't fucking know. He's bashful.
You know, it's
he's rambling.
It is ambitious.
Yeah, he's just making
ways, but in other ways,
words.
It's not.
He's just making up words.
You know.
Yeah.
So anyway, the rambunctiousness of the staff is really making this game become a crampumptious source of
shame.
It's gonna be fantabarastic, and everybody's gonna play it so much they're gonna go googaboo the week. I'm bashful.
I wipe my sack with it.
Our final guest, ladies and gentlemen, Sean.
Final guest.
Thank you so much, Sean.
Now we have one last announcement. Finally, we are getting that DLC for Postal 2.
And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we have successfully done the first ever PC Gaming Show!
First and last!
Thank you all so much
first
for coming out tonight. Thank you,
thank
Internet,
you so much for coming out tonight, and
well,
most of you for staying.
Enormous shout out to the sponsors, AMD, Bohemia,
please no, don't just end it with
Xbox,
bullshit.
Microsoft, and Digital Storm. They were all so supportive of the idea that PC gaming needed its own show as an open platform.
Is this
special
it?
Special thanks to the wonderful folk at PC Gamer for pulling so much of this off. Hooray, PC Gamer!
I just want something at the end.
And thank you once again for coming out
tonight. Got so many people on their phones.
Go play more video games. Bye.
Bye. 2.5 hours, you go, bye.
Boy, go away.
Bye. Oh, yeah.
Have
fuck
you. Have
you
seen an audience get up that quickly?
Fucking piece of shit. Nothing? I got a roller coaster fucking typhoon. And that's all I fucking get. Wow. What a piece of shit.
That rollercoaster tycoon, whatever the fuck, was the only thing of merit in that whole fucking thing.
Was it the only thing?
It was the only thing worth a damn to any of us, yeah.
Yeah.
Think of a shit about anything else. Everything else was like early access and Kickstarter bullshit.
I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm looking forward to Hitman Deus Ex, but that shit's we saw more before in less time.
Yeah. Right?
It was a talk show. It's not called the PC Gaming Talk Show. It's just called PC Gaming Show. Why? Why? I want to see what
even as a fucking talk show, it was a shit talk show.
Yeah, it was really bad. It was fucking horrible.
That was half an hour of talk show fucking stretched to 3 bloody hours.
Oh, Adrian said you suck at Smash.
What, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he sucks dick. Fucking...
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, so overall feelings?
6 out of 10.
Regret.
6 out of 10?
Mm.
That high?
I thought some games were interesting. I didn't see some of them before, so. I feel like fucking they should have announced more monumental shit, though.
Oh my god. I'm looking at the chat for the PC Gaming Show.
And people were just losing their minds, right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, people trashing it.
No, there's... Hold on. I want to look at some of these. Message deleted. There's so many message deleted. Gavin, come back. PC suck. Has been timed out. Is Half-Life 3 coming out? Slow down. Where's Gabe? Fake ending. Lol, no Half-Life 3? Did they show
Ubisoft,
Half-Life 3? Gabe?
Ubisoft is doing something right now.
Ubisoft? No, I'm fucking done.
Yeah, no, I'm just telling you.
Fuck a Ubisoft. They could fucking Ubisoft my dick. Unless they show fucking Beyond Good and Evil. That'll make up for the last 12
PC
hours.
Gaming Show goes out with the Nintendo sounding ship tunes. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got it done. It's over.
What?
Fucking 2 hours, three
Wait,
minutes.
Hold on, they're going back live.
What?
What? For a split second there.
Oh, did they go back off?
Oh, no, they're back again.
Wait.
They're back just to say thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. We can see in the chat everybody loved this.
Stay tuned. No.
We can tell by the 400... we can tell by the 400,000 message deleted that you really love this. Oh, you're all cunts. Bye. Oh, yeah, obviously.
It's just a host with a fucking middle finger up.
Gum cungeon. Terrible. This sucked.
There are a lot of people in the chat just saying this sucked ass. Which I'm glad, because it really fucking did. Holy shit.
That was pretty booty.
That was pretty booty. Alright, so that was the PC gaming bullshit show. I've seen worse car accidents, I guess. But, I guess that's it.
No one died during that conference, at least. So
of course. Well, no, there were some empty seats because people died.
Yeah, they melted away.
They fucking turned into ash, and then fucking some douchebag with a fucking dustpan fucking dusted them up.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the PC Gaming Show After Show. My name is Tom Marks.
Oh, thank God, Tom Marks. Fuck you. I hope you fucking shit. I'm done. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Say it, Christian.
Say what?
Goodbye.
Oh.